WXDE Lewis, broadcasting from the Price Honda and Acura Studios, located on Route 13 in Dover, home of the hassle-free buying experience. PriceHonda.com.
Good morning, everybody. Howdy, howdy. Jim Weller here, and you are watching Weller Does Delmarva. Okay? I'm ready for you. Are you ready for me is the big question. Anyway, it is the day after Black Friday. I hope everybody survived. And we are going to be open here at Weller's at 8 a.m. And we had a good day yesterday. We have a little special going. You can see it at wellers.com. And we had a good day. Speaking of a good day, to my left, preferably, presumably, your right, probably, is Colin Walls. And I bet he had a good day yesterday, too.
We had a great day yesterday. It was the opening day at Yuletide Farm.
Yuletide Farm, just right outside of Milford. I went there myself. I bought one tree for me, and I picked up two trees because I was a delivery person yesterday.
You came up with that trailer, dual-axle trailer.
You were all excited.
I said, there's no way you're going to fit 100 trees on that trailer. You're going to have to make two trips.
And I only bought three.
You only bought three.
What's that word in Spanish? Trace.
Disappointo.
Disappointo. Oh, okay. Anyway, Yuletide Farm. Tell us all about it, Colin.
Well, we are on Yuletide Lane, just outside of Milford, so Route 36, which is the Slaughter Beach Road there if you're headed to Slaughter
Beach.
Right
over the overpass.
Yeah, exactly. The overpass
almost
goes
walking
over
distance
Route 1
from there.
Yeah, almost from the Riverwalk. Yeah.
Almost.
You just probably don't want to walk with your tree back home.
Correct, correct. You could drag it, though.
He could. Okay. Could float it down the river. You get the tide going just right.
So, all right,
anyway, so Yuletide Farm, we are in Milford. We're a Christmas tree farm.
Yes.
This is our second year operating, my wife and mine. I do have to give a lot of the credit to my wife. She's done an incredible amount of work in preparation for all this. And we got 2 minutes left, Jim. We got these new cue cards.
It's going to be very hard on me.
It's very distracting.
It's going to be very hard on me.
They're bright red.
Okay. They were supposed to be an electronic sign.
Airplane
banner. But that's what I said on an airplane banner. All right. I'm trying to get my act together here. All right.
All right.
So anyway, with
all that
said.
Start that timer again because we just blew some time there.
Yeah. So Yuletide Farm, is it open today? Your wife. You were giving all the credit to your wife.
That's right. And Brooks interrupted me. So
yes. I got to say, I watch her work. She keeps the team moving.
Yep.
You know, she does a good job.
She does a really good job.
She's a worker.
She is a worker for sure, a hard worker. And I just like to do what she tells me to do.
That's wisdom. That's wisdom there. Right. You didn't even have to go to college to learn that.
Oh, I thought that was cowering in fear.
Oh, well, either one. Same thing. Just pronounced two different ways.
We're down to a minute.
A minute. Okay. Well, this is
going
to help me
get
better. All right. Well, anyway, Yuletide Farm. Do you website is yuletidefarm.com probably?
Yuletidefarm.com.
Let me guess the Facebook page.
Yeah, try
Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Open today?
Yep, we're open today. You know what? I don't even know what time we're open. I think we're open at 10.
Okay. Well, I know you'll be open by noon.
Check our website. Check our Facebook page.
There you go.
Yeah.
Yeah. And if you want to know what's going on, don't talk to the man that owns it. Talk to the woman that knows what's going on.
Right. She's the owner, too. So.
That's true. She is.
Yeah.
All right. Yuletide Farm today. Christmas trees.
That's right.
And they have a nice little store there and all kinds of things. That was nice to see. You got that homemade soap in there. My wife got some little ornaments.
Yeah.
Go ahead. What?
Now, have you ever seen a tent with carpet in it?
I've never seen a tent with carpet or heat.
Yeah.
And windows.
Right.
And a nice door.
Yeah. Glass door.
Glass door, right, on hinges.
Yeah.
So time is up. I am not going to be able to adjust to this stuff. Folks, this is like a learning curve for me. I'm trying to get more professional. Okay? So anyway, Brooks Ritter has come up with a new system over there. Brooks, how's that working for you?
Seems pretty good right now.
It's amazing. I cannot believe how quick a minute, 2 minute, and stuff like that goes. How much time have we spent already?
4 minutes.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Well, then I'm going to do better, I promise.
Clock is fast.
I think his clock is fast. But anyway, good morning, folks. And Yuletide Farm is your place to get a Christmas tree. I want to just mention a couple things real quick. He has this machine. If you look up Jim Weller, I did a little video on it yesterday. What's that thing called?
Little Shaky.
Little Shaky. They take the tree and set it on this machine, and it shakes it. It's the neatest thing. It reminds me of one of them exercise machines that you stand on. It has a belt that goes around you, and it just wiggles you. It wiggles that tree, and it knocks all the needles or leaves or
anything that's
birds' nests were flying. In other words, it was unbelievable.
I call it a squirrel remover.
A squirrel remover, right. So anyway, it was kind of neat. And then they slide it through this thing, and this netting is on it. And it was really cool. They drill the bottom of it because they have these really neat tree stands they sell. But you know something else that I realized that drilling was better at also? Even if you don't have one of those other tree stands that you sell.
Right.
It also helps the water go up better.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Right. So I think it makes a difference all the way around.
Maybe just we an could added get a real long bit and go up.
Go all the way.
The
right.
So if you're thinking
right.
About...
All right. Are we on the radio? Okay. Well, anyway, YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook, or go see him right outside of Milford on Route 36, just over the overpass, right. Like you're headed to Slaughter Beach on the left.
Yuletide Lane.
Yuletide Lane.
Right.
They named the business after the lane that was in front
that's
of
right.
it. That was pretty cool.
Good
All
idea.
Right. Anything else?
No, that's
Richard.
It.
Are you sure?
No, my time is up. It's been up for a long time.
Okay. And I definitely cannot manage my time. I've got a lot to learn today. Okay. All right. So anyway, what in the world is going on? Weller's is going to be open. Do we still have calendars to give away? I think so.
We sure do.
I don't know.
Yes, we do.
Brooks is doing something over there. He's very busy. Mm-hmm. Brooks is our executive producer, folks. You can rest assured on this. We could not do this without him. What?
Well, we're taking a phone call today, and this
Ooh,
is a professional
yes.
phone call.
I watched this lady singing with the Gaithers on some YouTube videos.
Yes.
Linda Randall. I get to do a phone interview with her because she's going to be singing and performing with the Reminders. We are live on the radio. I can't believe it. It is the Saturday after Black Friday, which is 2 days after Thanksgiving, which means I'm still full from Thanksgiving. I had a great Thanksgiving for those that are listening and were wondering. I'm sure you were curious. How was my Thanksgiving? It was wonderful. So I had a really good Thanksgiving, and my family came over and so on. Believe it or not, I struggle with the day off because I don't know what to do with myself on those days. But it is a great day to go look at automobiles and just ride around and so on, or just sit around home and relax. So anyway, good morning to you. Yes, Weller's Utility Trailers had a really good day yesterday. We had some Black Friday specials. We actually started on Wednesday, and what we did was we have all our trailers and generators already on sale, so I couldn't do any better on the price. So I thought, man, I got to do something. What can I do? Well, then I got crazy. Instead of just giving something small away, I gave something big away. I saw a picture where a man bought a dump trailer, and he's getting a free kayak. So we got a brand new hydraulic dump trailer for under $4,000 already on sale. And then we gave him a kayak and a paddle absolutely free. He was a pretty happy camper. So anyway, we're giving away one of three items today, and we're also going to carry this into Monday. It's almost every new trailer and almost every generator. There's just a few that it doesn't include. But basically, you buy the trailer, like a 5x8 landscape trailer, $999, okay? With that, you get your choice of a heater, an infrared heater, or a kayak with a paddle, or a flagpole. So you get a flagpole, a kayak, or a infrared heater, your choice with the purchase of most generators and most trailers today. We're open at 8 to 1, and we're going to be open again on Monday, 8 to 5, and that'll be the final day of that offer. So, we won't be undersold. We like to sell trailers. If you need a trailer, we'd like to sell you one. It's Weller's Utility Trailers, Route 13 in Bridgeville. Got a very busy show today. Got Barry from Dry Zone coming up in the 7:30 time slot. Then at 8 o'clock, I got Pastor Bob Weed from Eagle's Nest. Then at the 8:30 time slot, I got Kevin Short from The Reminders. And then I'm going to be getting Linda Randall on the phone, who's actually going to be performing and singing with The Reminders on December 8th and 9th. Okay, so the first thing I want to tell you is it's Saturday morning. You're watching and listening to Weller Does Delmarva. If you're listening on the radio and at some point you want to watch us, you can watch us at Facebook Live. You can also watch me at My Cozy TV. And if you ever want to go back and watch the show again or anything you missed, you can do that because we keep it right there on Jim Weller's Facebook page. And it's also on the website for WellerDoesDelmarva.com. If you are watching or listening and you ever want to advertise or be on the show, we have some ideas there for you. We work cheap, but we don't work for free. So anyway, Weller Does Delmarva gets results for its advertisers, and I'll tell you why. Because it's the only show like it. For example, this show is not only on the radio, it's also on TV, My Cozy TV. It's not only on TV, it's on Facebook Live. It's not only on radio, TV, and Facebook Live, it's also captured and kept on my website, Weller Does Delmarva, where we stream it there also. So anyway, it's kind of a unique little show. We're going on our fourth year of doing it, And if you want to be involved in any way, shape, or form, I am open-minded. Okay? Now, the next thing I want to talk about is one of my advertisers, which is Wilson's Auction. Now, Wilson's Auction is on Route 113 in Lincoln. And for those that know me, you know I love going to auctions. And there's a lot of good auction companies around here, but Wilson's Auction has been a big supporter of the show. Dave Wilson and his team have been advertising with me for a year or two now. And I just want to let you know, if you have some merchandise, if you're cleaning out your closets or your garage, or if you have a business that just has some old inventory and you just want to turn it into cash, and I mean literally turn it into cash, you take it to Wilson's Auction. They have a sale every Saturday, and by the end of the day, your stuff will be sold, okay? They have three or four auctioneers going all the time. They go into the evening. It starts today at 10 o'clock and will run into the evening. There's exercise equipment. I always mention that because I notice how people always eventually sell their exercise equipment. But also there's tools and building supplies. There is glassware. There is furniture. There is appliances. There's a little bit of everything. That's Wilson's Auction on Route 113 in Lincoln. Then on Tuesday nights at 6 o'clock, they also have an auto auction. So if you want to buy a car or sell a car, they can help you out there. Then next Saturday, mark your calendar, that is December 3rd, the annual consignment auction at Taylor and Messick in Harrington. It is a huge auction. There is all kinds of things going to be sold at auction prices. So if you're wanting a lawnmower or you're wanting a tractor or anything in between, there will be a big sale next Saturday at Taylor and Messick in Harrington. So if you have any questions, if you have something you want to sell, maybe you have a piece of property. Wilson's Auction also sells properties. So give them a call at 422-3454, 422-3454. Check them out on the web, wilsonsauction.com. Been serving Delaware, the Lincoln area, the Milford area, lower Delaware for over 40 years. And they do a good job, and I like dealing with them. I always enjoy going to one of their auctions. Now, don't forget, got some people going to be on live. Barry from Dry Zone's on his way. Brooks, are you going to be talking to me about anything? Because Brandon's
is off here today. Yes.
He's exhausted. He wore himself out eating turkey on Thanksgiving. Is that right?
I think he got too many phone calls last week.
You know what he did, though?
Yeah, so I am willing to give my phone number out so they can call me instead of him.
Really?
Yes.
You're going to give your cell phone number?
Absolutely.
You guys are crazy. People are going to call you when you're not at work. You know what I mean?
That's
I guess
fine.
When you're in sales, are you ever really not at work?
No, never.
Okay.
You're always at work when you're in sales.
All right. So anyway, Brooks, for those who have never seen him, there he is. You can see him, and he's doing a great job there behind the scenes. But listen, are you actually truly in sales today?
Absolutely.
Not till 9 o'clock?
Well, about 9:15.
9:15. Okay, so at the moment, do you want to give out Earl's cell phone number?
No, we'll give out mine.
You're going to give your number out now?
Yeah.
You do if somebody calls you during the show?
Then I'll just have to mute my microphone and let you keep talking.
Oh, my gosh. I wonder if I could think of something to say.
I think you would like that.
Okay. Give it away.
It's 448-0049.
302-448-0049. Call Brooks now to see if he really does have his cell phone on him. I want to know, are we moving calendars?
We are, yes.
What, did you move them from one end of the counter to the other?
Opposite counters.
Oh, okay. So you moved them around a little bit.
That's correct.
All right. Dusting the dust off.
Yeah, keeping the dust off.
Are people coming in and getting them?
Yes, they are.
Okay. Is there any more left?
There's still plenty.
Okay, so if you want a calendar, what we're trying to say in a roundabout way is we have calendars that we're giving away absolutely free. What would you like to talk about? You want me to show this heater now?
Sure.
Okay, this is a heater. It's really neat. I talk about them all the time. You can explain it, Brooks.
it's a 1,000-watt heater. Okay. You might have just turned it off.
Okay, great. Well, here it is anyway.
Yes.
It's a 1,000-watt infrared heater.
That's correct. And it has a thermostat on it to where you can set the temperature on the front of it.
Okay.
It's also got a built-in timer as well.
Okay. And you're getting a phone call.
I am getting a phone call.
Okay, I'll finish up. Brooks is actually getting a phone call. If you want results like that, folks, let me know. Anyway, this is a 1,000-watt infrared heater. And what I really like about it, like I say, I have a couple of them at my house, and they're really neat. Because what we do, my wife and I, is let's say we're going to spend some time watching a movie in a room or something, but we want it just a little warmer because I'm on all these blood thinners. So I want it just a little warmer, but I don't want to crank up the heat and heat the other six or seven rooms. that warm, so I use the infrared heater. And what it does is it heats objects, not air. So it like warms up the floor, it warms up the couch, it warms up different things. So if we have to open the door to let the dog out or the cat in, we don't lose all of our heat. So it's kind of a neat little heater. It's an infrared heater. You see these all over, but we have them at Weller's out of the box, on display, turned on so you can see how they work. You can touch them. Your cat can lay on them. A grandchild can touch them. They're not going to get burnt. They don't put out any carbon monoxides or fumes or anything like that. They're an electric heater, very efficient, literally operates on pennies a day, and we have them on sale, but the sale ends today. What does the price go back to?
You caught me off guard there.
Oh, my gosh.
If you lift up that little blue sticker there,
right,
it should say right underneath of it.
$137.
Yep.
I saw that, but I thought it was a misprint because it's on sale for $97.
Our marketing guy, he's
now
a little...
think about that discount.
He's a little on the crazy side.
Okay, so just think about it. If it was $137 and we knocked 10% off...
that would be $13.50 off of that, so...
right.
Roughly 100 and what?
20-something
dollars.
So if you knock 20% off, it's $26.
Uh-huh.
You're so still
that's 111,
over
100. Yeah. So I think we're knocking 30% off.
Yeah, $97.
Yeah.
Okay? So that's a good deal, but it does end today.
That's correct.
All right. Did we ever solve the mystery of whether it comes with a remote control or not?
We did not. I've been
okay,
a little
so
tied
it
up.
It might come with a remote control. It might not. That's a mystery question.
That's correct.
We were not able to access Brandon this early in the morning to get the answer.
I called him. He didn't answer.
Okay. So how many do we have?
We do have quite a few at the moment, but they are moving quickly. It's people are coming in and buying heaters.
But you got rid of quite a few in the past day or two.
Yes, absolutely.
You want to tell us why?
Because we are having a special for Black Friday. It actually started Wednesday, and it continues through Monday. But if you buy a trailer...
okay. 98.9% of the trailers are in this program.
That's correct. There's some stipulations
to what
trailers...
not used trailers, and then it's not the $599.
That's correct.
Okay.
But if you buy a trailer, you have an option of a couple different items that you can get for free with the trailer, which is already an incredible price.
Right.
So on top of the incredible price, we're actually giving you product as well. And the heater is actually one of those options that you can get for free with those purchases. It's actually been one of the more popular items right now.
Something? People have taken the heater over a kayak.
Over a kayak or a flagpole. I mean, a flagpole, that's a $200
plus,
I mean, realistically,
value.
Yeah, $200 plus, probably more like $300 value.
The heater they need now.
Absolutely. The heater is you can put to use right away.
Right.
The kayak you could put to use right away if you want to go get in the water with it a little chilly out. And the flagpole you could too, but realistically, I mean, they could take that out of the box, plug it in, and they're ready to go.
All
so
right.
I think that's why it's been popular. Plus, with
so that special started Wednesday.
That's correct.
And you're telling me so far the most popular giveaway item has been?
The heater.
The heater. All right. Well, anyway, you had a phone call?
I actually had a couple phone calls.
Really?
Yeah.
All right. Just people saying hi?
Pretty much.
Hair looks good.
Vicky gave me a call, and Jack Ennis gave me a call.
Jack?
Yeah.
Jack Ennis is up this early?
He's up this early, and he's watching or listening. One of the two.
Other.
Yep.
He's a mover and a shaker.
Yes, he is.
Okay. He's probably praying for snow.
Yeah, I bet he is.
He's ready for snow.
He asked me if I had my
sales
hat on.
Huh?
He asked me if I had my sales hat on. I said, absolutely, okay. All the time.
All the time.
It's invisible, right. But it's on there.
Yep. So good morning, Jack, and good morning, Vicky. All right. We got a busy day ahead, don't we? I'm kind of excited, especially Brandon is off, so we're a little shorthanded. But we're going to open at 8. Store's going to be busy. Got a lot of people going to be on the show, and we're just cranking things out. So anyway, I want to let you know that Weller's is open at 8. It's nearing the end of the year. It always makes me think of my accounting and taxes and how much am I going to owe or not owe or whatever and how do I avoid taxes. And I always think of my accountant, George Luff, Luff & Associates. I've dealt with them, gee whiz, at least 25, 30 years. They've been who I deal with, and they do a good job for me. And so if you're looking for an accountant to help you with your year-end planning or your taxes or whatever, Luff & Associates in Milford is always looking for new customers. So you don't have to be a business to deal with them. If you have an individual, if you're an individual and you just want somebody that knows what they're doing, they are CPAs, and they do know what they're doing, and it will help you with your taxes. Another thing they do that I've been promoting really strong is the fact that they do payroll. So if you own a business, you already know that payroll is very intimidating and a lot of work, okay? So, you know, you're busy trying to run your business, and you got to pay attention to payroll. So if you're tired of it and you want to focus your time on what you do best, which is run your business, and you want somebody to take over your payroll or help you with it or prepare certain reports or filings or anything like that, Luff & Associates has a system called Easy Payroll, and they do a good job. We've been dealing with them definitely over 2 years now here at Weller's, and I want to let you know that they will help you. Now, if your business does its own accounting or you deal with another accountant, that's okay, okay? They will still help you with your payroll services. So it's called Easy Payroll. They can help you with your W-2s or W-3s or your W-4s or your I-9s or direct deposit, payroll checks, 940s and 941 forms, your federal tax deposit, your state tax deposit, your quarterly reports, new hire reporting, whatever degree you need some help, they will help you out. So it's called Luff & Associates in Milford and Dover and Rehoboth. I'm going to give you the phone number. It will get you to any one of those locations. It's 422-9699, 422-9699, and it's luffcpas.com on the web, luffcpas.com on the web. All right, what is next on my agenda? I wanted to mention that Barry from Dry Zone is going to be coming in, and he always has a lot of information for us, and he's very knowledgeable, and I like talking to him. Barry actually recently has become more like their marketing person also, so he's wearing many hats, but I recently had him look at a project for me, and we may talk about it, we may not, but he gave me a lot of good information on a property that needs a little attention, and I'm kind of excited about that. So Dry Zone seems to be the experts in this area. They really seem to know what to do if you've got some, you know, crawl space problems or basement leakage or something like that. So that's Dry Zone. Then Pastor Bob Weed from Eagle's Nest is going to be on. That's the church I attend, and he does a good job, and I like to give him a hard time, but he really does do a good job over there at Eagle's Nest, and we've started a Saturday night service in the past year, and it's going good. So he's going to tell us what's going on at the Nest. And then at 8:30, we've got Kevin Short going to be talking about the Reminders. They're ramping up for a big tour they're getting ready to take, and they have two big events here in Delaware they're going to be doing on December 8th and 9th. We're going to be talking with them, and then we're going to get a young lady on the phone named Linda Randall, who I actually was watching some videos of her singing with the Gaithers, and a lot of people may know her from there, but she's going to be singing with the Reminders, and we're going to be chit-chatting with her on the phone. So, busy morning. Brooks, everything good on your side?
Yeah.
Good. thank you. You don't look overly convincing, but I'm going to believe you, okay?
I'm just trying to trace issues.
Trace issues.
Nothing okay. That's a major big deal. It's just a matter of
your kids like to draw?
Yes, they love to draw.
Well, get them to help you with the tracing.
You're funny.
Am I?
Yes, you are.
All right. Well, anyway, what else did I want to talk about? You know, no-nonsense office machines. I had him on our Wednesday night show, which I do want to mention. It's called Live with Walls and Weller, and if you'd like to be on that one, we're not charging anything for people to be on that show. So let me know if you have an interest in being on that show. It's on Wednesday nights. But we had Rick Fowler on again, and he's always just so knowledgeable, and I'm always so amazed at the things he works on, the things he can do. But he is going to be open today, and no-nonsense office machines, you say, well, what kind of place is it? Well, it's kind of like an electronic superstore. They have a little bit of everything, but they have it in new as well as used. But what they have that you can't get pretty much anywhere is service before the sale, during the sale, and most importantly, after the sale. So if you're looking for a laptop and or a tablet or something, I was talking to him about some laptops and tablets, and I said, I want it for my grandkids, but I don't know. He said, oh my gosh, he said age is important with the kids because at different ages they use those devices for different things. And he was saying, just tell me their ages and I'll tell you what they need. So if you're a parent or a grandparent and you're thinking about buying a tablet or a laptop for your kids or your grandkids and you're really torn, you don't know exactly what to do or where to turn, and you go to some stores and they're just all locked up in a cage or up there on the shelf, and you know, you can't get any help or anything like that. No Nonsense Office Machines, their staff will walk you through the process, help you with it. They do have items that are new, but they also have items that are used, and they've all been checked by trained technicians, and they all come with, you know, service after the sale. They stand behind everything they sell. So anyway, it's called No Nonsense Office Machines, and they sell laptops, tablets, computers, fax machines, gaming systems, and printers, and of course they sell copiers. That's how I started dealing with Rick. They're located just 2 miles east of the Circle, a couple doors down from Sports at the Beach Complex on Route 9. They are conveniently located because it's right there, and they also are very easy as far as hours. They're open pretty good hours, and Rick told me the other day, he says, you know, if I'm in there at 6 o'clock in the morning working, I leave the door unlocked because if I'm there, I'm open. So you never know when he's going to be there, and he may, you know, be very accommodating at an hour that he's not normally open. So I want to give you the phone number. It's 856-7381, 856-7381. It's No Nonsense Office Machines. Like I say, they're in there. They're in Georgetown. They're also on Facebook. You can also look him up as Richard Fowler on Facebook, because he was telling me, he said it might be 10 o'clock and somebody might shoot him a question 10 o'clock at night, and he may just answer it. So I'm very, very knowledgeable, very accommodating, very friendly, very affordable. It's called No Nonsense Office Machines. Just give him a try. 856-7381. I promise you won't be disappointed. All right. I see that Barry has arrived on the property. Brooks, what do you got you want to mention? Do we have a sale that ends today, one of our ads?
We sure do.
On the 26th. Is today the 26th?
Today is the 26th.
So I saw that the heater that's $97 is in that ad, and that ad ends today. So anyway, another thing I noticed is these Philadelphia Eagles party packs. I don't know who in their right mind would even buy these. What did Brandon call them? Things for starting fires.
Fire starters.
It's a little package. It comes with 24 plates, 24 cups, 24 forks, and 24 napkins, okay? So it's like a party pack. But these things would normally sell for like $25 or $30. I got a truckload of them. I'm selling them for $12.75 a piece, or three for $25. And I have to ask, because Brandon laughs at these things, but they have been selling pretty darn good. Who buys these, Brooks?
People like me.
You're an Eagles fan?
Yes.
No wonder Brandon thinks you're certifiable. Okay. All right. So you buy them, you like them, you have friends over, you have a lot of parties, and they always include plates, cups, forks, and napkins that say Philadelphia Eagles on them. Is that right?
I don't use them all the time. I'm kind of trying to hold out and
so
use
like
them
at Christmas, you use something different?
Yes. You know, I bought them to possibly have a Super Bowl party or something like that, if the Eagles ever made it. So they might actually go bad before I ever use them, because
I think they were bad when we bought them.
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
But, you know, everything looked good at the beginning of the season.
$12.75 or three for 25 bucks if anybody wants them. The infrared heater I mentioned, the 1,000 water, it is for sure going to end today, and it does come with a remote. And it's $97 if you happen to want one of them. We don't have 50 of them left. We do just have a few. Something else that we have right now that's a darn good deal is it's a gasoline-operated chainsaw.
Yep.
It comes with two bars, 14-inch and an 18-inch. Comes with a carrying case and everything.
Yep.
Brand new in the box, $117.
Yeah.
That's pretty deeply discounted, I would say.
Absolutely.
Probably about a $170 item.
Yep.
$117. So we have that. And then the Stanley roll-around toolboxes, do we still have any of those?
We do have a few of those left.
Okay,
yep.
And they come with some tools.
That's correct.
So it's a top box. Top box, bottom box, and how many pieces?
68-piece mechanic tool set.
All right, $140, $130, something like that?
$89.50.
For the bottom box and the top box?
And the tools.
And the tools.
Yeah.
68 tools.
68 tools.
Okay. Well, anyway, $89.50, they should be going. So, we got some deals, Black Friday specials, a lot of specials end today. Phone number for the store is 337-8228, wellers.com on the web. Going to take a quick break from the radio, going to talk to Colin Walls on TV, and we're going to continue with Weller Does Delmarva. Okay, so for those watching on TV, or for those watching on Facebook Live, or for those watching on the stream, good morning again. This is Colin Walls on my left, on your right, or he's maybe just in front of your screen. Colin, how you holding up?
I am holding up
well. How about
okay,
you?
Okay, good.
You're holding up weller.
Weller, that's right. Anyway, we're having a good time here this morning.
Give you all the answers.
All the answers. I got that clock already. I'm going to have trouble with that. All right. Well, anyway, we're talking about what? Wall Service Center is open.
We're going to talk about Yuletide Farm.
But Wall Service Center does open today at 8.
Right. Jim, I've only got 2 minutes left.
All right.
Brooks is over there.
Oh!
We can't waste
any
time.
I can't take it. All right. Do we have any time left?
We'll restart. Yeah, we'll restart the 2 minutes here.
I will say this. It's more noticeable than what you used to do. Okay? I will say that. It's messing up my mind. Anyway, folks, you're listening and watching. Weller does the... And Brooks has these new cue cards. We'll show them to you in a minute, okay? Okay. So anyway, I am getting ready to guest host the Dan Gaffney Show. And I am trying to become time conscious. And so we made these cards so I don't run away with time. I'm known for rambling on, okay? So Brooks holds these cards up when we have got 2 minutes left or 1 minute left and so on, because I'm trying to become more time conscious and do a better job and be more efficient, okay? And here's what point I'm at right now. My time is up. I was talking to somebody that does things for concerts, and they have these monitors on the stage that say, time is up. And then some of them say, quit now. And some of them say, exit the stage now.
Wow.
Like, get off the stage because the other people are ready to
Brooks
come on.
Brooks hasn't broken those out yet this morning.
Right. But anyway, so they do that because I guess a lot of programs and stuff are computer time.
Yeah.
And the computer doesn't realize somebody's taking
longer.
The computer
doesn't care.
Yeah, it doesn't care. So
that you've
anyway,
still got something to say.
Correct. And if you're doing a performance that you're performing the music, it messes you up.
Yep.
We do need to start his 2 minutes.
Let's start it now. Yuletide Farm.
That's right.
It is the Christmas tree buying experience of a lifetime.
I'm glad you said that.
Yes,
I'm making no guarantees of that.
I had a good time.
But you can have a good time there. You can actually come sit on our porch.
Yes.
It's all decorated and just kind of a nice, cozy atmosphere.
Yep. Family-friendly environment. I almost got a free cat yesterday.
Oh, yes.
Fortunately, I was smart enough to leave it there.
Right. If you
it had pet, one more meal there, it
if
said.
If you pet the cat, it
you get to own
yours.
It. Right.
That's right. Yes.
It takes ownership of you. But anyway, Yuletide Farm. What?
You must load it up.
Right. So anyway, open today for sure.
Open today.
Tomorrow,
I believe
for
we
sure.
open at 10 o'clock, 10 a.m. this morning. So,
okay.
Check us out. YuletideFarm.com and Yuletide Farm on Facebook. They're the best places to go to keep
Absolutely.
Up with all our current events. We do have, speaking of events, we have two events going on. One is December 10th. One is December 17th.
Okay.
If you want to get your kids out there, we're going to have movie nights.
Night, Under the Stars.
Yep.
I love it. Okay. YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook. Okay. That was a quick break. Okay. That was a quick break, everybody. So we are back. We are live with Weller Does DeMarva. Barry, get on over here before we're out of time. Keep an eye on these cards, Barry. All right? It's our new thing. I'm in training. I'm in training for something that's going to happen next week, and I got to do a good job. Okay? All right. Good morning.
Good morning. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. How are you doing today?
Great.
How is Dry Zone going?
Great.
Keeping everybody dry?
We're doing it.
Good. One basement at a time. One crawl space
at a time. One house
at a
time.
Right. It's how you eat an elephant. How do you cure wet crawl spaces and wet basements? One at a time.
One at a time.
All right. What do you got to talk about today?
Well, today, you know, we've been talking
about... Now, what's that sign say? That's documentation. Now the phone's ringing.
Uh-oh.
Whose phone's this? That's an alarm clock. Brooks, it's time to wake up.
Holy cow.
All right, let's go.
We're going
we couldn't
crazy
be any more professional.
I know, right?
All right.
We're going to talk about, you know, we've been talking about warming up the floors in a crawl space.
Right.
This is how we can warm up the floors, make them feel nice in a basement.
Really?
And using the thermal dry decking system.
Ooh, I think I've seen this before. This looks like hardwood.
Well, it's got...
Or tile.
It has the silver glow insulation on the bottom that we've shown before.
Got them little grooves in it, too.
And then it's got a magnesium oxide, non-inorganic board, so that nothing can mold or mildew will not grow on this.
I was getting ready to say that looks like magnesium oxide to me.
And then this one.
Non-organic version of it.
Allow you to put your Mill Creek flooring right on top of that. Really? So now you have this thick area here of a thermal break from the floor, okay. So it won't be cold when you get onto it.
I would say not. And them little grooves, are they for ants to crawl around?
Well, they can be, but they're really designed for the water to moisture and air to dissipate
just
through there.
Moving.
Yes.
All right, so you drop this off in a big pile and people install it themselves or get
oh,
a contractor?
Oh, no. We do that all for them. We
you come, do it all?
Yep. We come in and measure.
You put down this insulation and you put down the flooring?
Yep. And it's a very efficient process and...
Gee whiz.
We'll take care of it.
Because you can put carpet in the basement. It's not going to keep your feet from being cold.
Well, that's true. And it's also going to have some mildew and mold possibilities later on.
Now, let's say I wanted to do some work to my basement. Let's mm-hmm. say I wanted to go ahead and put a floor in there. Can I finance that?
You sure can.
For real?
We have 1 year.
We need to figure out some payments someday. Like, let's say I was going to spend $5,000 or $3,000. What would it cost me per month?
Oh, we can figure that out. Okay. I'll have a chart for that next time.
You have to run my credit first, probably, to see where I'm at. Okay, we have a question from the audience. Are you up for that?
Sure.
Okay. Watch them time cards, though.
I'm on the clock with my question, I think.
Okay.
So if, you know, like this stuff here, you guys just run down to Lowe's and grab that stuff and
oh, no.
Buy it? No.
No, this
lumber
is
liquidators.
We're the only ones in Delaware to have this. It's
really?
A basement system product, and we've been trained and certified to install it, and so you can't get it anywhere else but through us.
Wow. I'm going to guess it probably comes with a pretty good guarantee too.
Oh yes,
I've heard you talk about some like 25 year guarantees.
Yes,
on some things.
The flooring has a 10 year warranty on it.
10 years.
Mm-hmm.
Man, that's just hard to believe.
But the main thing about this flooring is, again, yes. controlling the water vapor, keeping the heat loss.
It's got more than one purpose, it seems
yes.
like. In other words, we're not just putting this down on the floor for a vapor barrier or a water barrier or
Correct.
Anything like that.
Mm-hmm.
We're putting it down also to insulate.
Yes.
And then it also has the functionality of being a floor covering.
Absolutely. And then, you know, people think of their basement, if it floods, it's because of a storm or something.
Right.
They forget about the plumbing that's hanging above it.
Yeah.
So that's where a lot of problems are. So, and if this gets wet, it's not going to matter.
I'm not going to be able to deal with these. I liked it when it was his fingers. All right.
We'll just have to change the signs up so he doesn't know it when he might say something.
It's really for me to be more squared away.
But yeah, so when we come in
down Tuesday.
So when we come in and do an inspection of your basement, you know, we talk about flooring, walls, whatever you might want to do,
really?
And we can show you options.
So you could come in and talk about different things, and some people might do this right now or that right now, or they might say, you know what, I'd like to go ahead and finance it and just be done with it and have it all done.
Absolutely.
Because I'm going to presume there's some energy savings to this, in other words, that may pay them back a little bit.
That's true.
Would make their house more energy efficient.
Yes, and it's also you're gaining usable living space.
Yeah, I would agree with that. Mm-hmm. So it's almost like doubling your size or adding some more space to your house without it costing a lot of money.
Absolutely.
Okay, now you also can do the walls of a basement.
Correct, and the ceiling.
Electrical. And the ceiling. Oh, I never knew about the ceiling.
Yep.
What was the ceiling?
Well, it's a drop ceiling material that it's
really?
Also it's guaranteed not to warp or dip. You know, like
warp or dip.
Well, you know, so you go to
that
stores
would be
with
good
ceiling
in bathrooms
tiles.
Too.
Yes.
Over here in my office,
mm-hmm.
I have a shower in my bathroom. And I realized when I had the building built, it took some special ceiling tiles in the bathroom.
Right.
Compared to in the office.
Well,
it has to do with the heat of the shower and stuff.
And that's
that
what this is.
Stuff.
It handles the moisture and things like that. Again,
really?
It's not organic.
Because it won't do what? Dip?
It's not going to dip or warp.
Dip or warp.
Mm-hmm.
I hate that dipping and warping.
Yeah, it looks pretty bad.
A dippy ceiling is bad.
And we can also do the full electrical with LED lights and, you know.
Oh, you do it all?
Do the whole package.
All turnkey?
Yep.
Dang, go on. That's amazing, isn't it?
And we can show them how we can write down to put the egress windows in, the emergency exits and things like that if they don't have one.
Really?
Because when you have a living space, you do have to have some kind of exit.
So somebody's got a basement, and they really don't know what they can or can't do. You're saying, just give me a call, come on in, and let me sit down and talk to you, and just say, here's what we can do.
Absolutely.
You just have to say yes to what you'll let us do.
And they can stop into the office there, and we can show them the walls. We use it right there in the building,
how
in the bread
room. How long do you work
the dry zone? It'll be 4 years this March.
Did you know about all this stuff before you went to
oh,
work
no.
there?
Oh, no.
Well, I mean, I don't want this to sound wrong. And you're not wearing a hat, so it's not going to matter if your head swells. But how did you learn so much in just 4 years?
Well, we go to training up to basement systems about each month somebody's going up the training.
Really?
Yep.
Because everybody I've ever talked to from Dry Zone is extremely knowledgeable mm-hmm. of everything they do.
We have classes ourselves in the office every Wednesday, about three times a week, that we review new things and review old things.
Very well-trained, well-run company, DryZone. All right, I've dealt with them, and time is up. Time is up.
Boom.
Okay, I'm glad you're not going to be with me on my new adventure.
Is he going to have a hook to pull us off the stage?
I have no idea. Anyway, DryZone, DryZone.com on the web.
Yes.
What number?
684-5034.
5034, 684, 5034. You give a call. They're going to send somebody out before the person comes. They send you this really neat packet in the mail. And you and I are talking about a project here ourselves. And I got the packet in the mail, and I was like, this is really neat. I should have brought it with me just to show it.
That's
so anyway,
right.
All right. Well, anyway, DryZone.com, 684-5034. Call anytime. Leave a message. There is 24/7 emergency service if
Absolutely.
Your basement floods or something goes wrong or you need some help. But anyway, anything else you want to say?
No, just stop by. We'll reopen on Monday after the holiday and stop by the barn.
All right. Thanks a lot. Ruth,
thank you.
Gene in Allendale. Thank you, Barry.
Have a good day.
Our time is up. Brooks, you're doing a good job with those cards. I have to be honest, they are hard on me.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. I got to rethink this one. But anyway, can I talk about Dr. T, Dr. Trillia, Dr. Bud? I bet they've been busy. People shopping and going out and a lot going on. This is the time of year I think people are busier than normal, you know. And if you need a chiropractor, that is what we're talking about. We're talking about Dr. Trillia, Dr. Bud at Peninsula Chiropractic Center. They've been around a long time, doing a great job. And I love dealing there. I deal there. My wife deals there. Brooks always chimes in and says he deals there and he's happy. But if you need a chiropractor, if you've never been or you've got a leg that's going numb or a twitch in your neck or Brandon gets headaches or my granddaughter has trouble with her hearing, you know, they help with all these different kind of things because it all starts with an adjustment and an alignment, getting your circulatory system working at its optimum capacity. So, it's called Peninsula Chiropractic Center. They've been around a long time. They're on Route 13 in Seaford. Friendly people. There's a lady named Joyce down there. Like, if you have insurance and you say, well, what does this particular insurance plan cover? She will get you all the answers and so on and so forth and help you out. They're very accommodating as far as time. I've been down there at 6 o'clock at night, 6:30. They also offer massages where the massage therapist works in conjunction with the chiropractor, so they make sure they focus on the right thing. So it's not what I would call a feel-good massage, even though they do feel good, but it's a massage with a purpose. In other words, you know, nothing worse than getting a massage, you got an ache or pain, and you still got the ache or pain because the person there is just massaging you. We're here, the massage therapists work hand in hand with the doctors to work towards a resolve to your situation. So anyway, been in business over 25, 30 years. Dr. Trillia is the owner-operator. You can like them on Facebook. They have a Facebook page. And like I say, they are very accommodating. You can call and say, man, I'm in a hurry, I'm really hurting, or I'm going on a trip and I just need to get an adjustment. They'll get you in. They'll work with you. If you say, I'm not in a hurry, fine. They'll schedule you to come in once a month or whatever works for you. So we have a special offer. A lot of people have took advantage of this offer, and it's a really simple one. And you probably have never had a doctor ever make an offer like this. But what we're saying is, if you're watching or listening and you give Peninsula Chiropractic Center a call and say, listen, I heard Jim talking about you on the show, Weller Does Delmarva. I don't even know if chiropractic will help me with what I got. They don't either until they talk to you. They're offering a free consultation with one of the doctors. You would give a call, make an appointment, let them know you heard about it on the show. And then you go down and you meet with them and you share with them what you're feeling, experiencing, what you've been through. And they will tell you, yes, this is a candidate for chiropractic care, or no, it's not. And I don't know of anybody that's ever made an offer like that, because it's a free offer. So give them a call at 629-4344, 629-4344. On the web, it's peninsulachirocenter.com. And they will get you in there, and they will give you a free consultation. And then you can decide if it's a place you'd like to do business. Won't cost you anything, no co-pays or anything. 629-4344, 629-4344. Like I say, they'll treat you good. All right, what is next, Mr. Ritter? I don't even know what time it is, but at 8 o'clock, I know Pastor Bob's coming in. Is that right?
Yes, he is.
Okay, and what is next on our agenda?
We should talk about our Facebook pages.
Oh, man, we got them, don't we?
Yes, we do.
You're not going to hold that cue card up for me, are you?
No.
Okay. I do need to say something. Brooks Ritter has put a tremendous amount of effort into this show. And over here to the right, he's got 2 minutes, 3 minutes, 1 minute and 30 seconds, 2 minutes, 16 minutes and 30 seconds. And, oh, it's got Brooks's name next to that. Okay? But it's, oh, holy mackerel, guests, 1 minute. Okay? In other words, so he has this show broke down to the minute, and he's done a great job of it, and that's what the cards that we're laughing about are all about, to help me do a better job of staying focused, okay? And if you can get that accomplished, you will be invaluable.
Yeah, that is an extremely tough
okay?
job.
Okay? All right, so what is next that you want to talk about? The Facebook pages?
Yeah, Facebook pages.
How many do we have now?
Oh, quite a few. Seven okay. or eight, something like that.
Really?
Yeah.
All right, a lot of work, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You do a great job with them, though.
And the nice thing is there's programs out there that help you manage more than
okay.
one at one time.
Well, you
time.
Still do a great job.
Thank you.
Okay.
But we have, obviously, Weller does the Marva.
Yes.
We have that.
And so all these pages, we're asking you, if you're listening or watching, if you would take just a minute and like them.
Like or friend, depending
friend
on
them, whatever they are.
Yep. Weller's Utility Trailers.
Okay.
We have your personal page, Jim Weller.
From Delaware.
That's correct.
Okay.
Weller Sheds and Carports.
Yes, Brandon's page.
Yep, Delaware Low Digit Surf Tags.
Yes.
And Live with Walls and Weller.
Yes, another show we do on Wednesday nights.
Yep.
All right, so anyway, like them, friend them, whatever you do with them, but we would love to interact with you through Facebook, all right?
Absolutely.
And you're going to be in sales today.
I sure am.
Do you have anything cooking, or are you starting every deal from scratch?
No, I have some stuff cooking.
Can I talk about this other stuff, or would you rather me not?
You can. There's a lot of stuff over there.
All right, you can explain it. You got the ad there in front of you?
I will make sure I do.
I always have to allow Brooks adequate time to get himself prepared. This is our cool holiday bargains ad. It's on the website. Is that right?
Yes.
And you are ready or not?
Because
I'm
going to
go get the stuff, but I don't want to walk away if you're not ready.
I have the other ad.
Okay, well, I'm looking at the one that says Cool Holiday Bargains, folks. So for any of you that can go to Wellers.com, you can look at it with me. And here are some of the things that we have on there. One of them is a 31-piece roadside emergency kit. All right, so this comes, it looks like, with a pair of gloves, a set of jumper cables, some pliers, some electric tape, and a few different things. And it's $7.77. So if you look at this ad, Cool Holiday Bargains at Weller's, you will see many different things that are very value priced. Here's a neat thing. We sell a lot of these. It's a hat, just a hat. And it
yep.
just says, don't tread on me. Brand new. I think they were like $15 or $17.50. We've reduced them down to $10 each. Another interesting thing we have is a 18-piece glass tumbler set. Now think about this. 18 of these little glass tumblers, brand new, in the box, for $3. I don't even know how to divide $3 by 18. Another neat thing. What was that?
Did I come out to like 60 cents a piece?
60 cents a piece?
Six cents a piece.
Why don't you do the math, Bruce? How much?
Maybe 6 cents a piece.
Yeah, maybe. All right. 18 times 6. I don't know.
You keep talking.
Anyway, electric drill bit sharpener. Electric drill bit sharpener. This is neat. You take like a dull drill bit and you put it down in it and it sharpens it up. They're only $15. And all these things, you're going to say, man, that sounds really cheap. Trust me, it's really cheap because we want to absolutely, by the end of this year, get rid of this stuff. So you're listening, you're saying, well, gee, I could probably buy those hats that say don't tread on me and resell them. You can. At $10, buy them at $10, sell them at $15, you can make money. So if you're listening and you own some type of a business or a store and you want to buy some of this stuff and resell it, it's absolutely okay with me. Here's another neat little thing we have. It's an extension cord. It's called a triple tap lighted generator adapter cord. So it has a 30-amp plug on one end. You plug it into a generator and twist it and lock it in there. But on the other end, it has three regular plugs. So it would make your generator be able to power more pieces of equipment or Christmas lights or anything you want. So anyway, we also have that. Have you found the ad yet?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. All right, so the next thing is these Baltimore Ravens little tractor trailers. It's 1/80 scale. It's a tractor and a trailer. So in other words, we've got what? The Milwaukee Brewers, the Texas Rangers, the Cincinnati Reds, the Atlanta Braves, and the Baltimore Ravens. So in other words, those are $7 each. And two for $10 or $7 each. So we have those. So if you go to Wellers.com, you will see this ad that says Cool holiday bargains at Weller's. You are allowed to buy more than one item. Here's a really incredible deal. It's a retractable air hose reel. A retractable air hose reel with 25 feet of air hose for $35. Anybody got a repair shop or a garage at home and you just want an air hose that you just pull the thing and the hose reel winds it up? We've got those, $35, okay? So anyway, there's a lot of good deals at Wellers.com. Cool holiday bargains. There's some of them we have one of, some of them we have 50 of, 10, 20, 30, and so on. Yes, you can buy. Here's a brand new half-inch air impact wrench for $35. That is definitely cheap. So again, just a lot of stuff we want to liquidate and get rid of. We put it on sale, so check that ad out. It's good till the end of the year, but no rain checks. You snooze, you lose. If we got it, we got it. And if we don't, it's gone, and we're not going to buy any more. So check that out there. I was going to show you some of them, but I didn't get to that this hour, but I will next hour. So anyway, got a lot going on. Pastor Bob's coming in at 8 o'clock. We're going to talk to him. We're going to pick his brain. We're going to really talk to him about some deep, heavy stuff. I hope he's ready for it. So I do want to talk about L&W Insurance Agency. Man, I have seen a lot of trees blown over here lately. I saw one where it hit somebody's little garage and caved it in and so on. And it just made me think about insurance, okay? A person whose house is next door to a building I have, I saw their trampoline blew into their deck and just did some damage to the trampoline and the deck. So anyway, it made me think about just insurance in general. And when I need insurance, I always call L&W Insurance Agency, whether it's auto insurance or home or health or life or commercial coverage. Whatever I need, I give them a call. But what I do like about them, and this is the one point they really want me to make, is that when you need insurance, you can buy insurance anywhere and everywhere. You can buy it online and so on. But what L&W offers that you cannot buy anywhere and everywhere is service when you need it. Okay, everybody's going to give you service when they're selling you something, but it's when you have an insurance claim and you say, I don't know what to do, I've dealt with you, you've been real good with me, and now you're going to turn me over to some 1-800 number, I don't know who I'm talking to, they don't even know where Sussex County or Delaware even is. At L&W, they get in the middle of the claim. They work between you and the insurance company to make sure that you are satisfied with the experience, because that is where the rubber meets the road. So L&W Insurance Agency is there before the sale, during the sale, and after the sale. When you need them, you call them, and they will help you with your claim. They're one of the largest independent agencies in Delaware. Been in business since 1932. So it's L&W Insurance Agency. They sell business insurance. They sell just personal insurance. Whatever you may need, you give them a call. It's 856-7828. It's 856-7828. LWinsurance.com on the web. LWinsurance.com on the web. They will take good care of you. If you are listening on the radio, and you are going to have to go and get in your car and get rolling or whatever, we also are available for viewing. So if you want to view us at Facebook Live, you can do that. On My Cozy TV, we're also there. We're also streaming at WellerDoesDelmarva.com. And where that's really good and where our advertisers really like it is, not only do you see or hear the show right now, but we have people go back at other times and watch it and catch up on it and make sure they didn't miss some special or something like that. So you get a little bit more bang for your buck. Traditionally, you buy an ad, it runs, it's over, that's the end of it. With this particular show, it's on when it's on, and it's also on whenever you want it to be on, because you can go back and watch it again. And we have a lot of that. We watch the numbers that, you know, people watch us now, and then we're like, wow, how did that number grow? And it's because people go back and check it out. So anyway, it's Weller Does Delmarva. If you want to be on or do some business with us, we have some advertising opportunities available. We don't work for free, but we do work cheaper than we should. So anyway, we're on every Saturday morning from 7 to 9 a.m., and it's called Weller Does Delmarva. It's live on Delaware 105.9, My Cozy TV. It's also on Facebook Live, and it's also being streamed at WellerDoesDelmarva.com. Then Wednesday night's got a brand new show. Colin Walls and I have started. It's called Live with Walls and Weller, 7 to 9 Wednesday nights. We've been having a lot of fun with that. That's on Facebook Live. And we want to let you know right now, we're giving it away. So we're allowing people to be on the show for absolutely free. Guys, last week's show, I can't even remember how many people were on there. I'm going to try to remember. It was first Rick Fowler from No Nonsense Office Machines. Then it was Amy Brown. Then I forgot who was next. Who was on?
Greg Ryan.
Greg Ryan. And then who? I know we had Kevin Short. Ron Letterman was on. That was kind of like a blast from the past. That was nice. Did I miss anybody? Denny Carroll talking about ham radio. I think that's it, but if I missed you, I apologize. Huh? And then Kevin Short. So anyway, it was the busiest show I think we've ever had. So lots of viewers. We take phone calls. We have giveaways. We have a lot of fun with that. So it's called Live with Walls and Weller on Wednesday nights from 7 to 9. They go to Facebook and like that page, and we'll steer you from there. All right, Brooks, is there anything else I need to know? Every time I look, you are very busy. You must have a lot of sales going on.
I got a lot of things going on.
A lot of things going on. Brooks is on overload, everybody. Is there anything I missed?
No, actually, you're pretty good.
I'm right on time, aren't I?
It's hard to believe that we're on time.
It's hard to believe, because if you saw this paper, can I hold it up?
I'm sure you can.
All right, there's two of them, folks. He's got this show broke right down to the minute. Okay? Can they see it or no? I don't want them to read every little word. All right, because I make comments about people on here. So, anyway, Brooks has got this thing broke right down to the minute, folks. So when he's over there holding up them little cards that says 5 minutes, 2 minutes, out of time, he's dead serious. Because he's like, why? Did I take it down too soon?
Yeah, you're good.
Okay. So anyway, that's it. As you can see, he's got me on a tight, short leash. And I'm preparing for something new. So anyway, I just want to be more timely and more precise and more accurate and more to the point. Laser focused is the way Brooks told me I need to be. Laser focused. So anyway, you're listening to Weller Does Delmarva. We are giving away calendars. That's going pretty good.
Yes. Yep.
You know, I have people tell me this, and I know it's kind of hard to believe, but it is true because I realize I don't get any calendars. People don't give away calendars anymore, it seems like. You know, probably because they're expensive.
Yeah.
But anyway, we do here give them away at Weller's. Oh, everybody's using their phone. That's what Colin's saying. Okay. Well, anyway, that's probably true, too. But anyway, one thing about it is we do give them away. I don't know how many we get. It's either 500 or 1,000, but we always run out of them, and everybody seems to be happy. So the store is almost open. It's probably open by now. The phone number to the store, if you want to see if they're really there, is 337-8228. That's Weller's Utility Trailers is going to be open today till 1. We have our Black Friday specials. We started them Wednesday. They've been going like crazy. So everybody has some specials, and it's kind of neat. We're giving away an item for free with the purchase of a generator or a trailer. It seems a little silly, so if you've been thinking about buying a trailer, you can buy the trailer. It's on sale, and then we're just going to hand you something absolutely free. And you say, well, what is it, like a $10 gift card? No, it's actually like a kayak. I don't even know who thought of these ideas. So we're going to give you a kayak and a paddle. I thought we could at least keep the paddle if we're giving the kayaks away. But no, we got to give away the kayak and the paddle because we don't want you out there without one. We're afraid somebody will get a kayak, get out in the water and say, you never told me I needed a paddle. Potential for a lawsuit. So we give you the kayak and the paddle in this promotion. Sounded silly, didn't it?
Yeah, it did.
Okay, but it sounded possible.
Yeah, I think we need to talk about letting the marketing guy go here. He's
well,
just giving
just
so much
thinking,
stuff away.
I had somebody say, who in their right mind gives away this stuff, okay? So anyway, we already shopped the Shure. We know our prices are right, but on top of that, you got three choices. You get an infrared heater, 1,000 watt, free, or you get a kayak with a paddle, free, or you can have a 20-foot tall aluminum telescopic flagpole, free. And people say, why are you doing this? And here's why. It's real simple. Real simple. I got so much product, I want to turn it into money. The last thing I want to do is go bankrupt owning millions of dollars worth of product, okay? I can't deposit the product at the bank. So I'm going to give you enough product. If I throw enough stuff at you, hopefully you'll get in here today before 1 o'clock and buy something. If not, we're here Monday. Oh, that's right. We're carrying it on until Monday, too.
Yes, we are.
All right. And then after Monday, it's over, right?
That's
so
correct.
That's when I'm happy. Now, what's this mean? You need to sign for that, too. All right. Brooks is over there, and we're rendering. We're wrapping up on the radio. We're going to get Pastor Bob on here in the next few minutes. So watch me at My Cozy TV, Facebook Live, right now. Switch over from the radio to that. All right, Colin Walls is coming to the microphone. Be prepared for these signs. Pastor Bob, there's these new signs Brooks has, so you're going to see them here in just a minute. I am personally trying to work on time management. I have a big project starting Tuesday, and I have to be better than what I am. Are you here?
I'm here.
And how are you holding up?
I'm doing great.
All right. So for those watching, is your mic now on?
It is on.
Okay. Anyway, for those watching, this is Colin Walls, owner, operator of Walls Service Center,
right,
which we're not going to talk about right
That's
now.
That's right.
But it is open.
Oh, look, time's up.
Time's up. Okay. Walls Service Center is open today, 8
we
to
are.
Noon. 422-8110, just in case you want to call them. And so, but we're not talking about them right now.
That's right.
Now we're going to talk about Yuletide Farm.
Yuletide Farm.
Yule.
Right.
And you know, I'm telling you, we got off on the spelling of Yule.
We did.
Okay?
I noticed that.
Yule Brenner is not spelled Y-U-L-E.
I think it is, isn't it?
I don't think it is. I think it's Y-O-U apostrophe L-L. Yule. Yule. Yuletide Farm. All right, Mr. Brenner.
Yes.
What's up?
Yuletide Farm. We're a Christmas tree farm, as
I
the name kind of implies, or at least Christmas time anyway.
Yes.
Yeah, so we sell Christmas trees, and we also have a little gift shop there,
oh,
so we sell
man,
different things
the
in there.
Neatest things. I don't know what Denise bought, and she actually thought they were priced wrong.
Really?
They were ornaments that looked like, I can't believe this. I'm not going to be able to do this. Hold on. What was I saying?
She
found
she thought
these
they were
ornaments,
priced wrong. Okay.
And she was worried that they were a dollar.
Right. Well, you can just pay
so
us what you...
she was worried that they were priced wrong.
Right.
But the lady in there, your young bride,
mm-hmm,
Jen, said, no, they're priced right. And then Denise felt bad she was buying so many. She Denise, like, never will buy the last thing on a shelf.
Opposite of you.
Oh, absolutely opposite.
You never feel bad when you buy so many.
If it's the last thing on the shelf, I want to see how many hundreds they have in the storeroom.
Yeah.
So, anyway, as funny as that sounds, I tried to buy 200... 7-inch tablets at a Black Friday special.
Uh-huh. And they said
the
no.
The clerk had no idea what I was talking about. Because the ad never said I could only buy one or two.
Right.
So I'm like, how many you got? Hundreds? Okay, well, I'll take two. 200.
Right.
Anyway.
And it, they it turned created, you down?
I had to leave. It was way, way beyond their pay scale.
Really?
Okay. Oh, yeah. No question about it.
Wow. You just burnt up a minute talking about your Black Friday sale.
I did.
We're down to 1 minute, Brooke says.
Okay. We
this is tough. Okay, what's
oh,
the question?
Oh, it's tough.
It is.
I've got between now and a few days to learn this system. Okay, here's a question.
Okay.
From the audience.
Okay, how long will a live tree last from Colin? Can you buy one now and still be okay for Christmas? I think they are.
Absolutely.
I can tell you from experience from last year
right.
that, yes, we had no problem with them lasting well beyond
either.
Christmas.
Right. I didn't either. Didn't you say somebody had one till March, or was that somebody else?
Yes, I've got a report of somebody saying they had theirs up until March.
You have no idea what it looked like.
It was still green.
Oh, okay.
It was
okay.
Still green into March.
Okay.
Yeah, green so that March. Was that was amazing. I can't guarantee
look at
it.
This sign.
Time is up. We didn't even get started.
All right. Yuletide Farm.
Yes.
Yes, the trees will last till Christmas, and if they don't, Christmas will still come on Christmas.
Yes.
Is that correct?
Right.
Okay. All right.
We
what
won't move the date up for you.
Can you buy one now?
And right.
Is it, okay. All right.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir, for that question.
Yep. Thank you.
All right. And we'd like some donuts when the show's over, if you're out.
So Yuletide Farm is just outside of Milford, just outside of town limits. Like
Route 36.
Route 36. Like if you're going to Slaughter Beach from Milford, right
go
on
over
Route 36.
The overpass
over Route 1.
Yep.
And we're like the third place on the left. There's a sign, Yuletide
Isn't
Farm
the
sign.
Is the farm connected to Yuletide Lane?
It is.
Okay?
It is, yes.
It's like
Isn't
they
amazing?
Named the place after the road that was already there.
Right.
Yuletide Lane goes right into Yuletide Farm.
It does. So if you want to come out, you can even come and get pictures there. If you want to get in the middle of all the trees and take pictures.
To this is no lie. I wish I had posted it. Jenny took a picture of my grandson climbing in the tree.
Yeah.
And she wants to come back and take pictures of him in the trees.
Oh, the willow. He was in the willow trees. Yeah,
yes.
We have a whole line of willow trees along.
I should have
along.
Posted it, but she really
there
liked
it is,
that
right
picture
there.
Of Brody in the
that
tree.
That is a great picture.
Can you hold it up? I don't
yep,
know.
Yep, I don't know.
I don't know.
I think our Zoomer is sleeping over there, so. Anyway.
They think we're out of time.
He said time's up.
Off.
Right.
Done.
He left.
All right. Anyway, it was a great photo op, too. The cat was nice. You're allowed to pet Colin's cat.
Right.
Oh, there's some photos inside.
Yeah, so we've got a little chair, like a red chair set up, leather chair set up right next to the Christmas tree.
Oh, can I play this video?
You can play that video.
All right. You're going to have to zoom in. Tell me when you're ready, because this is the video of the machine that shakes the trees. Tell me when you're ready, because I'm about ready.
I thought it wakes him up.
Uh-oh. Are we close?
Yeah.
This is a video, folks.
Go ahead.
Hold it up. Here it comes.
Well, listen to your commentary. Put your mic up to it. This is what they do with the trees
at Yuletide Farm. It wakes them up. It makes them come back to life or something like that. Not quite sure why they do it. I think, look at this.
This is amazing.
It reminds me of an exercise piece of equipment. But anyway, Yuletide Farm, like them on Facebook, YuletideFarm.com. I'm here picking up three trees, and a great place to get them, $45 or $60.
Yeah.
Great selection. Denise has never seen anything like it. Okay? So that's that.
All right. Thank you there, Cameron.
This is high tech here. We're playing a video on a phone.
The technology
and
we
zooming
have
up to it while we're holding a mic to it.
The only way it could be any better is if I bought something better. Okay?
Right.
We are out of time.
We are out of time. YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook. Check it
all
out.
All right. Anything else?
Oh, yeah. So anyway,
we can just keep going.
Right. Yeah. All right. So check out our events coming up, too.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
A couple
Thank
movie
you.
Nights.
Yeah. Time's
Movies
up.
Under
Time's
the stars.
Up.
I like it.
Time's
I don't know
up.
If Brooks ever went, but it was really nice. They had all these hay bales, and they were heated hay bales, I think, because they were rather warm. Hay, straw, I'm not sure what they were. What are you talking about?
Why you gotta call me out like that?
Did you go to the movies?
No, I had three sick kids then.
Oh, I thought you were there.
He's about the fourth person I heard say use the excuse of six kids. Sick kids.
Six kids.
Six kids.
Six
yeah.
kids.
Yeah, I had six
All
kids.
Right.
I'm gonna put it to you this way.
Okay.
Well, last December was a horrible month for my family.
But really?
It went through all of us.
Because there's so many in one house.
Yeah, exactly. You know,
and
there's
the kids
five
probably
of us.
Go to school or something
yeah.
like
well,
that, and they bring it home with them.
Yep, so it was a horrible
so
month.
So you were not there.
No, I wasn't. Unfortunately, I wanted
well,
to
let me
go.
Tell you what you missed.
Let me, yeah, tell me.
It was wonderful. It was a movie outside under the stars. It was kind of cool. And you could hear the creek rising. There's a creek back there. Okay? Anyway, it was good. We had a good time. We can't mention the movie, so don't mention the movie. Now we're going back on the radio. Now's when you say out of time, out of time. Pastor Bob, come on over when you get a chance. It's sweltering right in this area. Okay. All right. So anyway, this is the area for people on blood thinners. Are you on blood thinners yet?
Not yet.
Not yet.
Not
okay.
Yet.
Hang around me long enough, and you will be.
I will, yeah. What's he holding that 10 up for? Is that,
oh,
that's
my what, gosh.
Does that 10 mean that I'm a 10, or does it mean I have 10 minutes?
I'm going to let you decide. It's probably But anyway, good morning to you.
Good
this
morning.
Is Pastor Bob Weed from Eagles Nest Church.
Good to be with you this
Eagles
morning.
Eagles Nest Ministries.
Yeah. I like the number system. It's pretty cool.
Well, I'm in training for something. I'll tell you about it later. But anyway.
Don't let the church know that exists. You know, time's up. Sunday morning, I see Jimmy holding up the sign. Time's up.
Time's up. I can't stay awake any longer. I actually have heard that at some concerts and events like that they have these monitors down on the stage.
Mm-hmm.
That will say, they'll start flashing, time's up,
yeah.
time's up. And then they'll have one that says, stop now, stop now. They'll have another yeah. one that says, get off the stage. In other words, because a lot of programs, like especially now, there's a lot
yeah.
of programs that are timed.
Yeah.
And the computers and the music and everything is timed.
Kind of like a football game. You know, they take timeouts. You wonder why
right.
they're standing around.
So TV there's a time. Ballet coming up called The Nutcracker. And I am preparing to be involved in something starting Tuesday morning. And I've got to be very time conscious.
So you're going to hold signs up at the play?
I have no idea yeah. what I'm going to do. It's a big surprise. But anyway, I have to become very better at wrapping it up. Okay? So I
so
want to
gonna
thank
carry
you for stopping
Brooks
by.
With you, Brooks with you everywhere you go. You just say, time's up.
When
you're,
He's
with
got
a customer
these high-dollar
or...
high dollar memory things here. All right. So I want to thank you for stopping by. Your time is up. All right. Eagles Nest Church got a lot going on.
We do.
It's you got a lot of good series. Do you call them series?
We call them series. We do every
okay.
month. We do a different series.
Okay.
Basically, keep you know things fresh. You know to keep things moving, but also to give enough information in a series so that you know that you get a bigger picture, but at the same
Correct.
Time don't wear the thing out.
Right, because it's important. I mean, our pictures are always the small picture in front of us.
Yep.
Which seems catastrophic, but when you look at the bigger
context,
picture,
yeah, yeah.
you realize. It's more manageable than you think.
That's one of our challenges today. We get, you know, snippets and sound bites, but we don't usually get the information that's around it.
Right.
And context makes a big difference, like in the words we say, but stories that we hear on the news and things like that. There's a bigger picture
So we try to give the bigger picture, but also bring it down, whatever we're preaching on, teaching on, down to a personal level where you can apply it to everyday life. Like, right, we've been doing a series that we finish up tonight and tomorrow called America, Let's Talk. And we've just talked about American debt, where we get our security from, our budget, living within our means. And tonight and tomorrow, we're going to be talking about immigration. It's a hot topic, so we're going to talk about God's heart from the scriptures.
That's a topic
concerning
that affects
immigration.
All of us.
It affects all of us.
All of
Delaware.
Us.
I mean, there's 8.3% of Delawareans are immigrants.
Okay.
And so it's in our backyard, and you know, there's all polarized opinions. So we're going to look from the scriptures at God's heart, and try to get some wisdom from God's Word, the Bible, okay, on how to approach this subject.
That's a good idea. So, I've been going to Eagle's Nest quite a while, and mm-hmm, I find the messages.
Time's up, though. I'm going to bring that card.
Okay.
Time's
up. My time is up at Eagle's Nest. But anyway, I have found the messages to be timely and relevant. In other words, I'm not saying that you're always in tune or not in tune, but for me, it seems like it's in tune.
We try to speak
to
practically.
It,
yeah,
makes a difference. You know?
Yeah. So the Bible's very relevant. That's the thing, is the Bible covers the subjects that we address in life.
Yes.
And we just try to speak them in a way that is not Bible-ese or Christian-ese. We try to speak them in, you know, street terms so that people, right, can take it home and do something with it.
Today.
Today.
Be able to use it now.
Yes.
We,
yep,
live in a I want it, I need it now generation. So.
Well, when we have a lot of things coming at us. I mean, I was just reading a book the other day said that, you know, that the people in the Bible didn't have to face as many decisions as we have to face, if you think about it. All the technology and how fast things are. You know, somebody would grow up in the area that they were born in and stay there their whole lives.
True.
Today, we can choose where we live. We can choose how we live. It's amazing. So you have to kind of take the whole picture of the Bible to get the issues, but they're all there. Mm-hmm. But we are faced with speed. We got to make decisions so much, so fast today. Mm-hmm. It's amazing.
It is amazing. It is amazing. Everything's coming at us all the time.
It is.
Our phone is not just a phone. It's like an electronic ball and chain. In other words,
it's a gift, but it's a curse, as they say, you know.
In other words, I answer mine 24/7. I receive texts 24/7. I love the ones you get at 1 or 2 in the morning. I say, I hope this didn't wake you. Well, it did wake me.
Yeah, 3 o'clock.
Now I'm going to answer it an hour from now for you. So I'm going to wait till you get asleep, and then I'm going to text you back. All right, so Eagle's Nest, conveniently located in Milton.
In Milton, right off of 16 in Route 1.
Right. And Zion Church Road.
Zion Church Road. Mm-hmm.
All right. We have two services, Saturday evening.
Yep.
6:30, right?
6:30 to 8. We're done by 8. We try to be very punctual, especially with the kids.
That's true.
You know, kids, you know, they get routine, so we try to stay consistent.
So 6:30.
Somebody puts the times up sign for me and says, mm-hmm, actually, my wife has a whiteboard.
Okay.
That she gives me notes if I forget something. She'll give me
cool.
a little... Well, note, do this or do that.
She keeps you straight.
She's like Brooks. She's in charge.
She does a good job. Yeah. And her hands are probably full.
They are full.
Brooks' hands are probably full.
Yeah.
All right. Well, anyway, then Sunday morning, 9:30.
Yes.
Saturday night, 6:30. Sunday morning, 9:30.
And it's the same sermon, so it's
same
like
sermon.
People can choose
which
service.
If you like the first one, come again.
Yeah. Now, hopefully the second one's better. And like,
yeah.
I've had practice.
Right.
But it's not always the case.
It's like two bowls of ice cream.
Yeah. That's so right.
When one's not enough. But anyway, both times, we have things for kids.
Yes.
Because
yeah.
the one thing I you know, have a lot of people say to me is your church is very focused on the kids.
Well, we're focused on everybody, but we do believe that, you know, that every age group needs to be cared for.
In their age group.
In their age group has to be relevant, you know, like so kids aren't, you know, going to sit and necessarily listen to me preach on Sunday morning.
Correct.
So we have something that's relevant to their lives. We do a thing called Orange, and Amy Brown, you know, Amy, and she does a wonderful job, but it's something for the whole family,
mm-hmm.
and it connects to what the kids are doing on Sunday morning as well as something they do throughout the week.
Right. So you got Amy Brown with the younger kids, Kids mm-hmm. Cove, and then you got Matt Windsor who takes care
of
the 220 group.
Yep.
So between those two, we've got all the bases covered.
Yeah, the 220 group is what is our youth group.
Right.
Yeah.
So if you have kids, they're welcome, mm-hmm. and if you want to come, you're welcome, and it's a very welcoming church. What else would you say about it? I would say it's reasonably friendly.
We're warm and friendly, yeah.
It doesn't have a stuffy feel.
We're very real.
Very warm.
Authentic is the word we use.
You're going to see a lot of people you know because it's a sizable church,
mm-hmm.
serves the community well. Aren't we going to ready to be in the Christmas parade?
Every year we're in the Christmas parade in Milton, and I think that's on, is that on the 5th? On the calendar. My wife's not here to give me a note.
It's a Wednesday night.
Is it 7th? It's a Wednesday night. It's
the
first Wednesday of the month.
It's the 7th.
That's a great parade, too, by the way.
Oh,
if you take your family out, it's really a great parade.
Okay.
You know, it's very quaint. Milton's a very quaint town,
got a
especially
nice
at night.
Float that goes through that, mm-hmm. And it seems like Eagles Nest is always doing something out and about in the community. Like they leave the church frequently.
We try to get out in the community and give something back to the community. We want to make sure that we serve and not try to be served. We're trying to help people where they are in practical ways. Jesus did that. I mean, he fed people, he healed people, he did practical things, and then he shared the truth about the kingdom of God. So that's what we're trying to do. We're just trying to live in our community, be part of our community. If we were to leave,
we're made up of the community.
We are the community, and right. We're part of the community. But as a church, if we were to leave, not that we plan to leave, but if we were to leave, we want to be missed.
It's true.
You know, we want people to say, wow. So, we want to serve the community and teach people. You know, we have a culture that kind of wants to get. So by teaching and practicing this, we're trying to teach people, give more than you get. It's amazing. You'll be much happier.
Because life is about serving.
It's more fun to give than is receive.
It is.
At Christmas time, you know, I love giving gifts to my kids.
And everybody has something to give it if it's no more than a smile.
Smile, yeah, handshake.
Yeah.
You'd be surprised how many people need just to be, you know, acknowledged. Smile at them. Have a cup of coffee. We give free coffee out and just encourage people. Just talk to people.
Yeah.
And engage in conversation.
That is something you encourage before church and after church.
Absolutely.
There's fellowship out in the lobby and just there's tables and chairs and things like that. Hey, we have an app now, don't we?
We have a church app, yep.
I've never heard of a church having an app. It's just new.
Churches, you know, some of the bigger churches have apps. They're becoming more.
The big ones in Milton area.
The big ones in the thriving metropolis of Milton. Yeah. But it does help. We're finding that people really use the app. They've loved it.
Well,
I mean,
let's say somebody
amazing.
Gets the app. The app's free for starters.
The app's free.
You can get it on iPhone or Android, right?
Yep.
Okay. Can they listen or watch any of the services on the app?
They can iPod. I mean, I'm not the technological. All that wiring up there confuses me. But, yeah, you can
see. iPads and iPads don't have many wires.
The iPod is the where you can listen to the thing on your phone. Yeah.
Right. I think so.
Is that right?
Yeah. I think it's called a podcast.
I know the Bible much better than electronics. Yeah.
You're burning up time. You're going to get one of the signs.
We're down to 3 minutes.
You're going to get one of the signs any minute. Okay, it's an app. It says Eagles Nest, Worship, Connect, Serve. And, here we go. 2 minutes. I knew he was going to flip up one of them signs. So it says find us. Well, so you could find the church if you're lost or whatever. I see. Address pops right
sermons are on there. Archives are on there. Information is on there. Way to connect.
Okay. Yeah. It's 17.3 miles from here. Isn't that kind of neat?
It is, yeah. Oh, okay. Google.
How did they know that?
They know all, John.
They know all.
Jimmy.
Okay.
They know all.
I agree with that. So we have an app.
We have an
app. Do we have a website, too?
We have a website. Just type in Eagles Nest.
.ch.
www.ch.
Yep. Okay. Then we're on Twitter. You're very familiar with Twitter.
I do it, yes.
Really?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Blogging. And I used to do a lot of blogging, but it took so much time I had to stop. There's just too many things to do. But we do have a series coming up starting next week. We do our Christmas series called Put a Bow on It, and that will take us up to Christmas, which we'll be talking about joy, how to have joy.
Okay.
We can have joy. Christmas is about joy. How do we have joy in our lives? What is joy? And then on Christmas Eve, we have a really big Christmas Eve service. Something for everybody. The kids will love it.
Like.
It's 6:30. It'll be 6:30 to quarter of 8. So it's an hour and 15 minutes. We'll get you
out
of there.
We're going to have church on Christmas morning, too.
Christmas morning, we'll have a service.
9:30.
Yep.
All right. We're going to have a New Year's Day service also at 9:30.
New Year's Day, yep.
All right. A lot of stuff going on. All right. So anyway, eaglesnest.ch. I do know on Facebook and Twitter, it's eaglesnest.ch.
CH.
Kind of cool.
Yes.
So how we got it all. And then we got this app. So you can download the app if you want, and you can come visit us in person.
Come visit us in person.
Are visitors welcome?
They're very welcome.
Okay.
They don't have a home church. You know, we encourage people to go to their home church. But if you don't have a church, certainly welcome Eagles Nest. People will care for you.
For the holidays or
they're friendly.
Yep.
You know, you'll hear relevant messages and meet people that are trying. We're not perfect, but we're authentic and real.
I didn't hear what you just said.
We're not perfect.
Okay.
Maybe you are. Yeah, well, you may be. Time is up.
Listen, what's the phone number?
302-684-3149.
3149. So anyway, we're here, we're there, we're everywhere, we're relevant, we're alive. And
serve
the
community.
Part of the community.
Yeah,
so,
we want something for you, not something from you. That's one of the things we like to say.
How long have you been in ministry?
I've been in ministry full-time over 20 years now.
Okay.
But I've been involved in church service since I was 18.
Wow.
which we won't add up how many years that is.
Okay, okay. Let's not even get into it.
I've done literally everything.
I'm looking
in
at the gray
church.
Hair,
yeah.
And I'm thinking, okay.
Well, this hair is this is from you and the other side. Your son Jimmy.
It's a good thing you don't have more friends.
It's a good thing you don't have more kids, because
right,
I'd really
yeah,
be in
there
trouble.
You go. All right. Well, anyway, what else do you want to say?
Happy holidays, you know, Merry Christmas. Christmas is coming, so get in the spirit of it. And
how was your Thanksgiving?
It was wonderful. We had some family over. It was
fantastic. Your first one as a grandparent.
It is. I love being a grandparent.
Well,
it is awesome.
Are you doing a good job?
I don't know. You have to ask Jason. You have to ask him, but I can tell you, he's spoiled already.
Well, good.
Can't wait till Christmas. It gives a whole new meaning to it.
Well, that would be your first Christmas, too.
First Christmas.
Oh,
yeah. We went out last night and yesterday did some Black Friday shopping.
Okay.
And of course, it was all about Jason. Actually, it was the mall was pretty crowded, but it wasn't terrible.
Okay.
In fact, Thursday after Thanksgiving dinner, for the first time ever, I took my son out. He wanted a TV from Best Buy.
There you go.
And we stood in line for about 30 minutes to get in. And
you'll remember that, though.
And he will, too. It was first time I've ever done that.
Really?
Yeah, but
did
it was
fun.
Did
you buy the TV or get in line and say, oh, it's not what
no,
I
No, we
like.
Bought a TV.
No kidding.
Yeah, we bought a TV. I bought a TV for him.
Oh, well, that's nice. That makes the day even better.
Yeah.
All right.
He said, look how much money I saved, Dad. I said, well, you didn't save anything.
Right. You did. All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank you,
all
Jimmy.
Right. Pastor Bob, Eagles Nest, join us tonight at 6:30 or Sunday mornings. Sunday mornings at 9:30. EaglesNest.ch. What is next, Mr. Ritter? You're doing a great job over there. Those cards have got me messed up. I've got to think about this.
You do see me a lot more now.
No doubt. No doubt. I can tell you're there. All right. Have I talked about everything? I have seen Kevin Short has arrived. We got a big phone conversation coming up with Linda Randall. And Kevin Short from the Reminders is going to be here promoting a big event he's got going on. But have I missed anything? Should I talk about first-class heating and air?
I think that's a great idea.
Are they next on my screen?
Yep.
Okay. Next, I'll have a teleprompter up here. So anyway, First Class Heating and Air is the company that I deal with for my properties and my business and my home as far as heating and air conditioning. And they're a great company to deal with. Time of year, you know, you're going to start using your heater more and more. When Sean's here talking to me, one thing he amazed me with is the average heater or air conditioner runs like 300-plus days a year.
That's
a
lot of
days. You think about that. You think about that. You know, your vehicle might not run as much as your heater or air conditioner does. So it's kind of important to have them serviced every now and then. So they have service agreements. That's what I personally have. I like it. You buy a service agreement. They come out twice a year. They check everything. They make sure your filters are working good, that everything is operational. And I kind of like it. So that way, if it gets cold real quick and I got to turn on the heat, I don't have to worry about a thing. Or if it heats up one day and I got to turn back to the air conditioner. If they didn't sell you your equipment, they still service all makes and models, and they'll do a good job for you. When they arrive, their vehicle is lettered, so you know it's really them. And they also have uniformed employees. They do background and drug testing on their employees. And I have met a lot of their staff, and they're very attentive to detail. They care. They introduce themselves, and they make sure that, you know, I understand what they're doing. If my wife is there and she has some questions, they make sure she understands what's going on, and they're just a great company to deal with. So it's called First Class Heating and Air. They actually also do plumbing. I've had some information given to me from them about that. They've given me some ideas on some projects I'm thinking about doing. So anyway, they've been serving Delmarva and Maryland now for over 40 years. They've been serving it. So they're upstate, they're downstate, they're everywhere in between. So their phone number is 934-8900, 934-8900. Their website is the words firstclasshvac.com, firstclasshvac.com. If you have any questions, you give them a call. If you have any questions, you can call me. I've dealt with them on numerous projects and been very, very satisfied and very happy. I find their prices to be spot on. They do offer financing if needed, and they even have 24/7 emergency service also. But whenever I've needed something done, they got to me in a timely manner, and by my having the service agreements, I also get a discount on any parts and labor for anything I need pertaining to heating and air as well as plumbing. So they also offer home performance tests and things to see if you need anything done to make your home perform better. So it is First Class Heating and Air. They are 934 800-934-8900. Check them out on the web at firstclasshvac.com. Okay, Brooks, tell me, how you doing over there?
I'm juggling.
Man, you look like today something has got you thinking.
I'm trying to figure out why my normally when the station comes back into the board,
right,
it won't come over to the TV side of it.
Okay.
But today it is.
Wow. So well, it's always an opportunity.
Oh, yeah.
There must be 100-plus wires in this room. So anyway, so I want to thank you for all that you do. We could not do it without you. Then there's Colin the Second right over there next to you. He does a great job. And then Colin the First, I guess, does a great job. Numero Uno does a great job. So we work as a team. And then there's Kevin Short sitting over there from Mid-South Audio. A lot of his equipment in here. And we could not do it without any of you. So thank you all. We're on our fourth year of doing this radio show, and this is show number 169. It's our 46th show on Cozy TV. I want to thank Bob Backman and the team over there at WRDE for allowing us to be part of their TV family. And I want to thank you, the audience, for watching and listening and being interactive. We take phone calls. We have contests. We have giveaways. We have more giveaways. And then once in a while, we make a little money. So anyway, we thank everybody for being involved. We've got all these different sponsors that have supported the show over the years, and that's been good too. So with all that said, I'm going to move on now, because if I keep talking, I'll be taking an offering. So anyway, if I go much longer, we'll be passing the offering plate. So I do appreciate each and everybody, and I appreciate the audience. I meet people. I don't know if you ever bump into anybody, Brooks, that listens to you or hears you or anything like that, but I sure do. Do you ever?
Absolutely.
Colin, how about you? Or Kevin, do you guys ever have anybody mention that they heard about you or your business on this show? I'm just curious.
I for sure do, yeah.
For sure,
absolutely,
do?
People do. Yes, yes.
Okay.
Especially you when you come in.
Okay, I see. Yeah. Colin, I heard about you on Weller Does Del Mar. But how about you, Kevin?
I hear about it quite a bit, actually.
Okay. What
ran
do people
to somebody.
Say to you? I can't believe you hang out with that guy.
Why are you hanging out with Jim Weller?
No, he was the lowest bidder.
I actually ran into someone yesterday that said that they heard me week before last. So,
oh, really?
Yeah. Oh, so you know, people are. People are listening and viewing
and responding,
you know,
yes.
which is the best thing. Yeah.
Yep, I agree. Now you're on TV, Kevin.
Now I'm in the green room and on
you're
TV.
You're in the green room.
Yeah.
I have to ask, have you recently got a haircut?
I have, yeah.
Okay, it looks. What's that word, tight? And it looks pretty good.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I went to your barber.
Really?
Yeah.
And so you have about 20 minutes of conversation and then a two-minute haircut.
Yeah, that's exactly
what's to make you feel like you're getting your money's worth.
That's exactly right.
Wow. So how was your Thanksgiving?
It was wonderful.
Was it wonderful?
It was.
Okay. Did you stay out of Debbie's way?
That's what made it even more wonderfuler. Yes.
Okay. Yeah. You did a good job of that.
I did. I stayed out of her way, and she prepared a great meal. My parents were over, and we had some friends, and it was a wonderful day.
Good. Do you mind if I tell everybody who your parents are?
No, not at all.
Okay, because
I tried
posted
to snag Dad to come over here with me today, but he wasn't out of bed yet.
Well, I so, posted
you know,
a picture.
And he's 82, and he wants to sleep past 7:30. That's fine with me.
And you're allowing it?
it's okay, yeah.
Your dad is Harold Short.
He is.
And a lot of people know him as Harold Short Plumbing.
Yep.
From Georgetown. But I posted a picture of his truck in the Return Day Parade, and somebody said, I did not know that was Kevin's dad.
Yeah, you know, we're
going to have to market him better.
That was his 1926 Model T.
Really?
Stored
like he
up.
Had it in 1926?
No, actually, but it belonged to his uncle.
Really?
And he bought it from the family at an auction. Yeah.
Wow. And he had it restored and all fixed
up? He restored it.
He did it.
Yeah.
Wow.
He and his brother-in-law restored it.
It is a beautiful truck.
It is. It's a national first place winner. Yeah, okay. He won first place in the nation with that truck.
And I don't want to neglect to mention your mother, but I don't know her name.
Dora. Yep.
Okay. And you call her mommy, mom,
mother?
Mom,
yeah. You know, and she was there on Thanksgiving and having a great time. She's and she was riding through the parade with him.
I saw her. Yeah, she was smiling.
Riding shotgun in the Model T.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah.
They have a model. They have a Model A they used to date in.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But, you know, they have, you know, that this.
Now they have a house.
The truck. And now they have a house. The truck predates the Model A. So.
Really?
Wow. Yeah, he has quite a collection. He has a Corvair, and he has a Henry J, if you remember those. And that's
does
the dog's car.
Does he have a Corvair with AC or no AC?
The Corvair has AC because it's a convertible.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Okay.
That's why you keep your hair trimmed so tight.
That's exactly right. Yeah.
So don't get your eyes when you're driving.
Exactly. So.
All right. Well, good. They look like they've done a good job of raising you. I would like to get their opinion on
they,
what kind
they
of child
clean me,
Kevin
you know, most
been.
Of the time. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, they've been very supportive of you.
They have. Absolutely. Yes.
So, anyway,
wonderful
I just
parents.
Wanted to take a minute and say that is who Kevin Short's mom and dad are.
Cool.
So, anyway. All right, folks, we're going to take a break in a minute or two, but I am just, you know, it's Thanksgiving, and I'm thankful for my advertisers and the team that supports this show. You may not realize it. These guys get up at, like, 5 o'clock Saturday morning to be here by 6 o'clock so the show can go on at 7 o'clock and so on. Oh, Colin gets up at 4. 4 for Brooks, 4 for Colin. All right, Colin the second, what time do you get up on Saturday mornings? 5 o'clock. All right. I get up at 5:30. I get up at 5:30. So good team, good people. Thank you all. Thanksgiving is a time we think about all the good people around us. I think about the team over here at Weller's. They do a great job. Just like Brandon being off today. We miss him. We yep. notice it when somebody's off. You know, it makes a difference. So anyway, you're listening to Weller Does Delmarva. We're going to take a quick break from the radio. And speaking of thankful, I'm thankful for Fran, who's back there at the studio making things happen. So thank you, Fran. So we're going to take a quick break from the radio. We're going to be back with the last half an hour of Weller Does Delmarva. Stay tuned. All right, Colin Walls, it's your turn. You're going to get the time cards here in just a minute. All right, Kevin, you're going to have to figure it out. All right, 2 minutes already. I got it now. He's telling me there's 2 minutes.
We okay. start off with two?
We started off with
okay.
two. Now I'm getting it.
All
now
right.
I'm getting it. All right, so anyway, Colin,
yeah.
Wall Service Center is open. I know that's
it
not
is.
Our hot topic of the day, but people may need to get, you know, something done or a serpentine belt changed
yeah.
or oil change or headlights checked.
Yep, they opened at 8 o'clock, so 422-8110, or just stop in, 220 Northeast
right
Front Street, downtown Milford. Yuletide Farm.
Okay, hey. Here we go. Let's talk about Yuletide Farm.
Yuletide Farm, yep, so we are a Christmas tree farm. We're open. We officially opened yesterday at noon, and
yep.
we are ready to go this morning. I think 10 o'clock we're going to open. We're just off of Route 36, which is the road that takes you from Milford to Slaughter Beach.
Just over the overpass.
Just over the overpass.
Right.
It goes over Route 1. Yep, we're about the third place on the left. After
yep.
that, you'll see a sign that says Yuletide Farm,
nice
Yuletide Lane.
Lane,
yep, tree yep. tree line drive
Bring
that takes
camera.
You back there.
There's some picture, photo ops there for you and your family.
Yeah,
there
definitely.
There really is, truly.
There
I'm
sure
kidding.
Is. Yep, yep.
Bring your camera with you.
Between the Christmas trees, you know, the
trees.
Chair in the tent there
yep.
next to the Christmas
the
tree
gas.
And the beautiful fake fireplace.
Yes.
There's lots of different...
So,
Lots of different
things.
Photo opportunities.
Right. Can we talk about the movie nights?
We can talk about the movie
because
nights,
Because people
yes.
can buy tickets now, correct?
Yes. We got to do it in 1 minute or less,
okay.
Brooks says.
All right.
So you can go to YuletideFarm.com right now and buy your tickets for December 10th, the Polar Express. We're going to be showing that.
Okay.
December 17th, we're going to be showing Frozen.
Are you allowed to name the movies?
I just did. So
okay. He did it.
They'll
folks.
Explain to me in the letter why okay. I can't do that.
All right. So anyway, two movies. I went last year. It was really kind of neat. In other words,
it is.
You know, years ago I used to go to the drive-in movie, but this isn't like sitting in your car. It's, I don't know if it's hay or straw, but anyway, you got bales and stuff, and
right.
some people brought their own chairs.
Mm-hmm.
You had heaters, and you had hot chocolate, and some other little goodies.
Right.
But anyway, it was really kind of cool, and my grandkids went, and kids were, you know, some were playing, some were paying attention, but it was just a nice family-friendly atmosphere, watching a movie,
right.
big screen, everybody's having a good time. It was really, really nice. So anyway, how do they get tickets? How
well,
do they get
They can
tickets?
Go to YuletideFarm.com. They can order them there. You can also pick them up right there at the farm if you want to stop
oh, so
in
like
and
if you come
buy
get
them
a
there.
Christmas tree or look
yes,
around.
You can buy because it is, there is limited seating.
Right. But
and you
want to
make sure you
idea.
Secure your ticket.
You know, like if you're listening right now and you got
right.
employees and they have kids
mm-hmm.
or you got some family members and you're like, man, I have no idea what the, this is a great.
Well, I want to mention that children two and under are free also. You know, I know they really aren't into movies two and
okay.
under. So
okay. they were the ones running around.
They were the ones running around. Yep.
Okay.
So and
good thing is
it's
short.
Okay that they
okay.
can run around.
Right.
So YuletideFarm.com, Yuletide Farm on Facebook.
Or come so. See you right outside of Milford on Route 36.
That's right.
Yuletide Lane. What's the address in case they're going to use it?
5282 GPS? Yuletide Lane.
5282 Yuletide Lane.
Right, yeah. But just search Yuletide Farm on Facebook or you know, even on, in your Google Maps and it's easy to find.
I'm going
to
do it
comes
right now.
Right there.
Here
so,
we go.
Are we talking about our Wednesday show also?
Maybe.
Okay.
Yuletide Farm.
Let's see what Google says.
Oh, maybe Yuletide. The word maybe. Oh. Hold on. Here we go. Yuletide Farm. I'm going to quit talking. Yuletide Farm.
There it goes. Got it that time.
Holy mackerel. It picked up every word I said. Here you go. How far
Yuletide
is it?
Yuletide Christmas
Open
tree
today,
farm.
10 to 8.
Here you go.
Here you go, buddy.
There we go.
All right.
Google
Open
says
today,
10 to 8.
I don't 10 know if that's 8. Accurate or not.
8 is definitely not accurate.
Okay.
It's 5 o'clock.
5 o'clock?
Yeah, we close at 5.
Okay. So anyway, you can learn a lot by going there and enjoying
yes.
the place. All right. All right. Wednesday night, live with Walls and Weller.
Yes.
Brand new show. Will this week be our third week?
This will be our fourth week.
Fourth week. Okay.
Yeah.
I've lost track already.
Fourth show. We need Brooks
okay.
to take notes of how many shows we've had.
Anyway.
He needs one more thing to do.
If you want to be on, we are not charging anybody to participate at the moment.
Do we know who we're having on this coming week?
I can't remember.
Okay.
My memory
are we full?
No, we're not full.
Okay.
We're not full.
Well, I've got one suggestion, so I'll let you know who it is
okay,
in a couple
please.
Minutes.
But I've got about 40 people that I have contacted.
Okay.
So I really am stirring things up.
Wow.
So anyway, yes, for sure. Last night I spent a lot of time on it, and yes. So, yes, people can be on.
And they're all going to say yes to this coming Wednesday.
Hopefully. I don't know. Who knows?
40
but anyway,
people.
But anyway, I spent a lot of time on it last night.
Good.
And we got some things cooking and lined it up. So, but we're going to continue past the first of the year and probably not going to charge. I don't know. But anyway, we're back on the radio already. All right. So for the radio audience, I was mentioning our brand new show on Wednesday nights, Live with Walls and Weller. And you can watch that at Live and with Walls and Weller. Check it out on Facebook if you would. Now, let me see what part of the show I am in. Do I need any more ads to be done? Is that our caller? Ooh, we got a phone call. This is going to be Linda Randall, I'm hoping. Good morning.
Good morning. Is this Jim Weller?
It is. Is this Linda?
This is Linda. How are you?
Real good. Just to let you know, we are live on the radio. We are live on Ooh. TV. We are live on Facebook Live.
Okay, so we're live on the radio, live on Facebook, and live on what other social media outlet?
Social media, Facebook Live, and then at WellerDoesDelmarva.com. We're live there.
Okay.
And a local radio station called Delaware 105.9. And a local TV station. We're also on TV. It's called My Cozy TV.
Oh, wow. So I'm live TV via phone. Okay, so can they see you on television?
They can see me. I'm a short.
Okay.
I'm vertically challenged. And I am follically challenged.
That's okay.
When you're
done whatever
with,
works.
When you're done with this interview, if you want to just look up a guy named Jim Weller, and it's J-I-M, not G-Y-M, Jim Weller.
Okay.
You'll be able to see us, because you're also going to see, to my left, maybe your right, a young man named Kevin Short from The Reminders.
Hi, Linda.
Okay. Hi. Oh, Kevin, hello. How are you?
I'm well, and glad you called in. We're looking forward to being with you in a couple weeks. And
Oh my! And I'm already. I know we're gonna. Sure, we're gonna talk about your two of the songs. I know that you've written. I'm sure there was a ton more. Sanctuary and El Shaddai and all those great songs. It's gonna be a great time. Looking forward to it.
We are excited about it. Yeah, and those are of course the Reminders Trio is Ed Shockley, John Thompson, myself, and John is in fact the writer of Sanctuary and El Shaddai, and we'll be doing those. We're going to get you to sing Sanctuary with us, I believe. So that's always a lot of fun. We'll do that.
That will be great. I'll hang out on the course. I'll leave the verses to you guys. As a matter of fact, Jesse Dixon. Are you familiar with Jesse Dixon?
I that's how John wrote that song. John was producing Jesse's album on that song, and that's how that song came about. Yeah. So John and Jesse are very we're very good friends. Yes.
I did not know that, of course, Jesse's been gone about 3+ years, and he sang that so much on the Gaither Tour, and he would play the piano and sing it, and it was just great, very worshipful, so I'm looking forward to being a part of that.
It is a great worship song. The rest of the stuff we'll be doing is original Christmas music, and I think you'll be doing some of your Christmas tunes from your Christmas album,
sure.
but We're looking forward to it. We got two venues. I'm talking more than Jim is, but the Swartz Theater.
That's a first.
Yeah, that's a first. It's the Swartz Theater in Dover, Delaware, and then Crossroad Community Church in Georgetown. Have you been to Delaware before? Have you played in Delaware? Well,
yes, I am. Was born and raised in Washington, D.C.
I know that.
And, of course, a lot of our summer vacations, we were either in Atlantic City before it kind of went to the, well, I won't say anything, but Atlantic City and then Ocean City, Maryland. But I've been in Delaware. I used to sing with my dad way back in the day when he was out in his itinerant ministry and all those things. But I was there with Gaither for some concerts, but it's been a minute. We've got some invites to Delaware, but we haven't been able to work those things out, so it's great to get back on the East Coast.
We're going to be glad to have you and host you here in Delaware. It's the next to the smallest state in the Union, but we've got a big heart.
But one big thing, Linda, that you will love once you get here is tax-free shopping.
There you go.
Really? So Delaware is tax-free shopping.
Correct. And there's no spending limits at any of the stores.
You know,
so you will be allowed.
First of all, you guys are not going to believe this. For female shopping is probably my least favorite thing. Okay, because here's the thing. I'm actually leaving Nashville, Tennessee right now. I was with my family and my little brother that sings in the group, Newsboy. So we were at his house this Thanksgiving. And so we all went to the mall yesterday, probably like maybe 12, 13 of us, and I did it because we're family, but that is not my favorite pastime. I guess I'm like a guy when it comes to that, or most guys. I'm not a big go to the mall and go shopping, but that's funny, though. So tax-free, I didn't know that. That's pretty cool.
So, in other words, increase your credit card limits before you come. And spend some time shopping.
This is a typical Jim Weller interview. We started talking about music and ended up talking about tax-free shopping.
Correct.
So
it's the value of Delaware. It's a small state.
You guys are funny this morning.
Yeah. I'm really looking forward to seeing you and hearing you. I was watching some of your singing with the Gaithers on YouTube, some of the videos and stuff. And you have a wonderful voice and a wonderful spirit. And I'm excited about you being with the Reminders. I think you're going to be a great combination. It's going to bless our community, and I'm excited about the whole event. It's going to be good.
Well, I'm honored, and I don't know who the person was that was supposed to have been there and could not make it, and Bob called it, I'm not going to say he was in a total panic, but he was trying to remedy something here.
We've got 30 seconds, I'll tell Linda the story. We had Ed Bruce, and is a country singer. I don't know if you know Ed or not. Ed wrote Mamas Don't Let Your Babies Grow Up to Be Cowboys.
Ed
recently became a Christian a few years ago, and Ed and John have been doing some things together, and he's done some things with the Reminders, but he got ill a couple weeks ago and was not able to come out and join us. So we had a guest, for these two shows, and so we reached out to Linda, and she said she could do it. So we appreciate
that. Well, I'm just thankful. It's really cool how God works those things out, So we're so looking forward to it. You guys, the Lord bless you. Thank you for allowing me to have a little moment this morning with you, and you guys have a great, great weekend.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you, and have a good day, and we'll see you when we see you. Bye-bye.
Okay, looking forward to it. Bye-bye.
Okay, bye-bye. Well, Kevin, that was a pretty nice...
Excellent.
Called in.
Yeah, sure did.
And I hope I represented you well.
Did I give the dates, 8th and 9th?
I think you did.
I don't know if I did or not. 8th
at
the Sports Center.
Well, you did give them twice. Now you have 3
nights. 8th at the Sports Center.
It's Thursday night at the Sports Center.
Yep. And the 9th
really
is at
a... environment. Like, if you've never... I want to throw this out here. If somebody's never been to the Sports Center, make a point of going to this.
Yep.
It's a nice...
I've got tickets.
It's a nice family environment.
If you want to give a pair of tickets away, we can do that. So if anybody calls...
I don't know how to do it because I got my phone call.
Oh,
okay. We can bring it right
okay.
Here.
Okay. So we're going to take a call. What do you want to do? Give a ticket away?
A pair of tickets to the Swartz Center. Yeah, for the 8th.
All right. A pair of tickets for free. First caller right now, 337-7300. You think it's going to work?
Oh, yeah.
337-7300. 337-7300. If you want two tickets to the Swartz Center on the 8th, to see the Reminders and hear Linda Randall with them. Then on the 9th is at Crossroad Community Church.
Yep,
right here
that's
in
correct.
Georgetown.
Yep.
Okay. Or, I don't know, it is called Georgetown.
It is Georgetown. Kind of in the middle. But
kind of in the middle, but they don't mind. 337-7300, if you would like to win two tickets for free to hear the Reminders along with Linda Randall You think that's a legitimate call?
Hello?
Is this a legitimate call?
Yes, it is.
How you doing?
Good, how are you?
Are you watching or listening?
Listening.
Listening. On Delaware 105.9?
On Delaware 105.9.
Is that your favorite station?
Yes, it is. I listen to it going to work, coming home from work, flying at home.
Oh, my goodness. So everything you ever need to know is right there.
That's it. That's where everything's at.
All right. And do you know the reminders? Have you ever seen them or heard them?
Yes, I have.
Okay. And you would like these two tickets?
Sure.
All right. Well, here's what you've got to do. You're going to have to give us your name.
Okay.
All right. What is your name?
Susan.
Susan?
Yes.
All right. So the first Susan through the door. What?
We need their last name.
Oh, her last name?
Yeah.
All right. Last name?
Okay. Let me spell it for you, okay?
Okay.
B-L-L-E-R-B-U-S-C-H.
That's exactly what I was going to guess.
It'll be a will call.
Okay. Now, what it'll be is, do you know where the Swartz Center is in Dover?
Yes.
Okay, they'll be at what's called will call. So you have to go to will call, tell them your name. They might want to see a photo ID, and two tickets will be waiting for you.
Okay,
so
nice.
That would be the night of the 8th.
The night of the 8th, correct.
Okay.
All right, thank you. You have a wonderful day.
All right, you too. Take
God
care.
Bless.
All right, God bless you. Bye-bye.
Bye.
All right, that was good. So we heard from Linda Randall, and we've talked with Kevin Short, and that is going to be a great event. The 8th and the 9th, the reminders on the 8th are going to be up at the Schwartz Center. You can get tickets there on their website now. And also, they are going to be playing at Crossroad Community Church on the 9th. Brooks Ritter, I think I need to mention our good friend Jerry's Lawn Care. Is that correct?
Yes, that's
correct.
Other
than that, I think I've done a pretty darn good job of letting you steer me through this program today. Okay? All right.
2 minutes.
Jerry's Lawn Care. 2 minutes. Okay, let me get moving. That's what I got to work on. Jerry's Lawn Care. Okay? In fact, I just talked to Jerry. I got somebody I know that's got a tree in their yard that's leaning towards their house. And they're like, who would you get? I'm like, I'd get Jerry Santoro. Give him a call. He's going to give us an estimate and then see what's involved in cutting down the tree, either digging up the stump, leaving the stump, or grinding up the stump. So he does tree work. He also does lot clearing, which means he also sells firewood, seasoned firewood. Small quantities, big quantities delivered, or you pick it up. Anything you need, Jerry can help you out there. He also winterizes irrigation systems. So if you have an irrigation system and you want it winterized, he can help you with that. Even if he didn't sell it or install it, he can winterize it for you. He also sells and installs pavers, E.P. Henry Stone products, and he's actually certified in it. I didn't even know that existed, but he said, oh, no, there's training and so on. It's not just I went and bought them and put them in. I know what I'm doing. His estimates are free. He's been in business over 10 years. So you give him a call, whether you need lawn care, pavers, a lot cleared, firewood, a tree cut down or trimmed up, or your irrigation system winterized, Jerry can help you out. His phone number is 363-6025, 363-6025, jlc-llc.com on the web. jlc-llc.com on the web. I do want to talk about Weller's Utility Trailers because they are open, and I'm going to grab some specials if you can talk for just a minute. Do you have the ad ready so you can talk about it? All right, so
sure
Brooks
do.
Ritter is going to tell you about some of the things that I'm going to show you, okay? You ready, Brooks?
How do I know what you're going to actually pick up?
You're going to have to, I don't know. That's a good question. So I'm making room on the table for those that are watching us, and you're going to have to tell me the prices of everything. This is something I was on vacation one time. I was on vacation, and I bought hundreds and hundreds of hitch covers that are blank, just like this. I think they can maybe see it. I'm presuming they can. But anyway, thank you. How much are they, Brooks?
$7.50.
Okay, and I think we used to sell them for like $20. So we're down to our last handful. I forgot how much you said.
$7.50.
$7.50. Okay. What's neat about these hitch covers is you can letter them. Okay? We don't do it. You can do it. But you can buy it and put a message on there. Praise the Lord. I hate taxes. Go Trump. Whatever you want to do. So anyway, any kind of message you want to put, you can put it on this hitch cover and put it in your hitch. And they are, I forgot what he said already.
$7.50.
$7.50. Now, what's the next thing I'm going to get? I want to grab one of these Air Zookas. And I'm going to let you explain it while I demonstrate it, okay?
Sure.
These are a neat item.
It is a, it's called an Air Zooka. It's basically an air cannon. He's going to shoot the camera.
Did anybody feel it?
He is shooting at us with this air cannon. Basically, what it does is it actually shoots a puff of air. So, if you had a room full of like fog or something like that, you could really tell the difference. You could see
cats love them. Cats love them. Okay. In other words, they're $10. All right. Now look at this blind over here, and I'm going to shoot this blind. Is everybody watching?
We're watching.
Is the audience? I'm asking the people on TV. Is everybody ready? Here we go. See it? They are the coolest gift. If you are sitting there saying, I need a gift like no other gift somebody's going to receive, this is the neatest gift. They're only $10. What do we used to sell them for? $20, something like that?
Yeah.
All right. So it's called an Air Zooka. What? Okay, here we go. Here we go.
You
the hair all over my arm blue. All right. They're really cool. I have learned ladies that spend a lot of money on hairdos do not laugh when you shoot them with this. It bothers them. Air Zookas, $10, okay? So we have those. Now, what's the next thing? Oh, this is that triple tap cord.
One of them.
This is one of them, okay.
Because we have a couple different ones. That one doesn't have the lighted end, but we also have one with a lighted end as well.
Okay. All right. So this one here, it plugs into a 30-amp plug, like on your generator or if you got one in your garage or something like that, and it converts it into three receptacles. Mm-hmm. So that way, whether you're camping or a contractor and you need to power more tools or whatever, these things here are normally like $70-$80. I got them right now for $45, okay? So that's just another item. Now, what's the next thing? These rubber boots, okay?
These are rubber galoshes.
Fit right over your shoe.
Fit right over your shoe. Thank you, Brooks. And they are actually on sale for
$6 each.
$6 each. How much is a pair?
You could get two sets of them for $10. Now that's
so it's $6
pairs.
A foot. So it's $12 a pair.
$6 a pair.
Oh, it's $3 a foot.
That's correct.
All right. So it's $6 a pair.
Or two pairs for $10.
$6 for a pair of boots or two pairs for what?
$10.
So that's a his and her special.
Absolutely.
Okay, so we got them.
Yes.
All right, what's the next thing? I want to, oh my gosh, how many trailer stores have this? This is a 5-piece bathroom set, okay? You're not going to get them at every trailer store. So here's the deal. We want to get rid of this mess stuff, this wonderful items, okay? We want to get rid of this stuff. It's a 5-piece bathroom set. It has a beach motif, okay? And they're $5, all right? Soap dispenser, soap dish, toothbrush holder, tumbler, dustbin with lid. Choose from real dried flowers or real seashells design. Who bought this stuff? How did I even get something like this?
Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was you. And I have no
clue. You know, I haven't been on vacation. That's why you're not seeing. Every time I go on vacation, I buy truckloads of stuff.
We need to keep
you
from
going. One more nice little thing. This is good for the family or the kids or give it as a gift. It's a little thing that looks like a loaf of bread, okay? And it's called Our Daily Bread. It's a promise box, and it has 240 little cards in it that have just little, you know, inspirational things. And they're kind of neat. So anyway, if you want to get one of them to give to a teacher or your Sunday school teacher or a friend or a neighbor or whatever, how much are those? $4?
That sounds right.
3 for $10. All right, folks, this is not a joke. This is a real live promotional show. Every one of these items is a good deal, a darn good deal. A deal a darn good deal. And we please support the cause. The cause is we want to sell them cause we got too much stuff. Okay? That's the cause. Cause we got too much stuff. Anyway, go to Wellers.com. This particular ad says cool holiday bargains. All right? Did I get enough or do you want more?
I think you covered enough for today.
Okay. This is quite an impressive array of things. Oh, here's something neat. This here is a drill bit sharpener. Isn't it cool looking?
It looks like a black piece of plastic.
See all the little holes, all the different drill bits go in there? So anyway, it's a drill bit sharpener, brand new, $15. I mean, if it just saves you two or three drill bits, it's well worth that. So anyway, go to Wellers.com, look at the ad that says cool holiday bargains, okay? All right, next is, what is next?
Whatever you want to be next.
I have one more ad, don't I?
No. You've covered everything.
Am I all done?
You're done.
Well, let's end the show early today, okay? I've got to go. I've got things to do. No, I'm just kidding with you. I do want to let everybody know I am going to be guest hosting the Dan Gaffney Show Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday. So I am trying to work on my time management skills. And so if you would please be so kind as to give me a call on Tuesday morning, Wednesday morning, or Thursday morning from 5:30 in the morning till 9 at Delaware 105.9. I'm going to be taking callers, and I'm going to be letting you pick the topic that we talk about. If not, I'll call you, and then I'll pick the topic that we talk about. But anyway, going to have a lot of fun with that, and I just need to work on my time management skills is what I'm trying to do. But anyway, Brooks, what else? You're going to be in sales today. You're all excited.
Yes.
Want to give your number again or not?
It's 448-0049. Give me a call. Come on out. Take advantage of these great Black Friday specials.
Take advantage of Brooks.
I'm definitely looking to move some units today. So I am available. Come check us out, and we'll get you fixed up.
I was calling you over, Colin. All right, me and Colin are going to talk real quick about our new show, Live with Walls and Weller. And we've had a lot of fun with that. He says we're on our fourth week. I think we're on our third week, but I don't know for sure. But I always yield to his wisdom because he retains information better than I do.
We've done three shows. This will be our fourth one coming up.
Okay. Well,
that's
how you can tell. Dead giveaway. We have not done three shows.
We have.
Okay.
I
believe you. I believe you. I'm not going to burn up time because I'm holding them cards up.
That's right. You only got 2 minutes to argue this point out. Time's up.
All right. So anyway, Live with Walls and Weller is a Wednesday night live on Facebook show.
Mm-hmm.
We want people to like our Facebook page, which happens to be called
Live with Walls and Weller.
Okay, so like that. If you want to be on, give me a call. The best number to reach me is the 337-7300, and we will work you in. We had some people on from the Ham Radio organization.
We did,
that was very interesting.
It was interesting.
And then we also had Amy Brown, who was celebrating a one-year anniversary of, you want to take that call?
Runiversary. Do we want to take this call? Let's take it.
No.
Let's take it.
Take it. All right, we're going to take
Brooks,
this call.
Brooks has a phone that's about 40 years old, so it doesn't have caller ID on it.
You're live on the radio. Hello?
Hello, Jim.
Yes.
Hey, this is Paul Iannucci. Just wanted you talking about your trailers. My daughter was just in there and bought an enclosed trailer from Brooks here about a couple weeks ago, I think. And I was thinking about it because, you know, I'm probably going to be moving back to Ohio, and I was thinking, you know, I'm going to need a trailer, and I was almost thinking about having to go rent one, and now that they have an enclosed trailer, I'm going to end up borrowing that thing.
That's the nice
thing. We're keeping all Weller trailers in the family.
Well, thank you. Now, listen, Brooks can't hear you. How did Brooks do for you?
They're happy with the trailer, you know, and I've been happy with mine. And when I told you guys a while back about getting D-rings put in, and couldn't ask for a better job. Professional, looked like it come right out of the factory, and worked out great. So
I'm glad
we didn't put them in. I can tell you that because it would have been a mess.
Well, thank you for the call, Paul, and have a safe journey and stay in touch with us. All right.
Oh yeah. Well, it's not going to be till after the first of the year sometime, but I'm trying to line things up. So.
All right. Well, thank you again, and stay in touch.
Oh, I will.
See
you guys.
Bye-bye.
See you, Paul.
Bye-bye. That's Paul. Good friend, good customer, good man.
Yep.
All right. Brooks, he never did comment on how Brooks did, but he likes the trailer.
He steered away from that pretty tactfully. So
Brooks does a good job. You just ask his mom. loves him to death.
Right.
All right.
So anyway, live with Walls and Wellers.
Wednesday night.
We were talking about Amy Brown. She had her runiversary.
Amy Brown ran a mile or greater every day for a year.
Wow.
What an accomplishment. What an accomplishment. Greg Ryan was on. We're actually going to his house tomorrow to have something made.
Are you?
Yeah, them puzzles.
Excellent.
He's going to do them while we wait.
That's cool.
All right. And who else was on? We had the ham radio people, Denny Carroll, and that group. Rick Fowler, No Nonsense.
Uh-huh. Time is up.
And time is up. We're
for the radio?
Out of time. All right, everybody. Thank you for listening. Tune me in Tuesday morning. I'll be guest hosting the Dan Gaffney Show. We'll be back next Saturday, live with Walls and Weller, Wednesday nights at 7. Have a good weekend, everybody. All right, now we're going to finish up with the TV people.
And the Facebook Live people.
And the Facebook Live. Right. So, love to hear from you. If you got any comments, what in the world do you think of the show? How do you like our wardrobe? How is our hairdos? And what about the content? Okay, I did say that later.
1 minute.
1 minute
oh,
left.
Now he got Colin
oh,
in on it.
Now he's
it
in
looked
on
like
it.
So holy much fun, he had to do it.
Yeah. So, anyway, love to hear from you. How do you like the show? If you don't like the show, tell me what you want us to do better. Anything short of canceling the show, I'll be happy, okay? Yeah. I do have a lot of fun with the show. It's kind of like my hobby, and I really like it. Colin is a big help to me, and
we have
the team
fun.
Over there is doing a good job. So if you ever like to be on, we've got some advertising opportunities, whether you want to buy a commercial or buy time on the show, I'm willing to talk. So the best number to reach me is 337-7300, WellerDoesDelmarva.com. And if you would like our page on Facebook. How much time have I got left?
About 20 seconds. 15 seconds.
We don't have a 20-second card, do we?
15 right, seconds.
Don't forget, check out Yuletide Farm today.
Yes.
Weller's Utility Trailers is wanting to sell some trailers today. Call us. Come see us. Have a good weekend. Other than that, God bless you and have a good night. Bye, everybody. Bye.
Time is up.
Bye.